Hello everybody and welcome to the stream. I am Bogus Meat Factory. How are you folks doing today? Happy Friday? Happy Thursday. Oh my goodness, it's Thursday. A little under the weather, don't mind me. Voice is kind of shot. Happy Thursday, everyone. It's a day stream time. We don't get to do this very often. They're very rare because something comes up. I've been sick. I tried not to be, but it is what it is. I've been taking lots of medicine. I'm drinking some tea right now. I'll probably brew me another cup here a little bit later. But December is tomorrow. We're a day away from the wonderful world of December. An amazing event held every year by a wonderful streamer, Artyom Havoc, who's going to be joining us tomorrow for some Battlespire co-op. Yeah, just kick things off, we are going to be playing, the Elder Scrolls, an Elder Scrolls Legend Battlespire, which is the first-person dungeon crawl RPG that also has multiplayer co-op up to 8 players, which not a lot of people play. A lot of people kind of dismiss it comparatively to something like Morrowind or Daggerfall. And it's been a bucket list game for me for a big long time, so I'm really curious to see how it's going to go. We'll give it a shot, and hopefully it'll work out. We've got a whole bunch of people lined up, Big Mike Yocho, Lapilagos. We're all going to be joining me for that. And again, don't mind the voice. Again, still sick. Energy's there, but the voice is not. Oh, baby. Sakura talked to me. My moderator Sakura talked to me just the other day. Because I was playing Return to Moria in the night. And I was in the voice chat just in case Lip would come in and join me. And they pop in and they're just like, "You need to rest." And I was like, like, "Oh my god, you sound terrible." And I did sound terrible. But yeah, so today, in honor of December, to prepare for December, we have a project that we have to do. We have to go and draw all of the box art of the games that we are going to be playing for that month. Zerval says the tea is already empty. It is. It's now empty. Yes. I just topped it off. It was a chai tea. A spicy chai tea. Very good. Oh my gosh, it's so good. I'll get me another cup going here in a bit. How are you doing today, Zerpal? It's good to see you. So we're going to do MS Paint box art of all of the games that we'll be playing for December. Poorly, I will add. My tools that I will use is this mouse. And we are doing MS Paint box art of all the games. There's quite a few games. I don't know if we'll get through all of them today. We'll find out. I'm not an artist. I wish I was using Windows 3.1 MS Paint, but no, it's just Windows 10. It's not the fancy one. Good morning, Audio Eric. I'm not an artist. I would never claim to have any artistic skill or talent. All I'm going to do is try to poorly draw these things for the own entertainment of myself and others. Lurk, by all means, Audio Eric, and thank you so much for coming in for the lurk, even. I appreciate your presence, nonetheless. I'll be here. Everything becomes art once it's MS Paint. It's true. That's why it's an art. Hey, look at that. Look at the title. It's art. It's an art stream. That's what you got going on. So, to talk about this, if you want to see what we have in store, you can go to DOS Ember. Hold on. I should have a bot for this set up already, but I don't. DOSEmber.com. DOSEmber.com, yeah. Bam. You can look at each of the individual people participating. There's 120 participants, I think, signed up for this right now, which is crazy. If you find me, there's a section for what we'll be playing. And we got quite a list. We have, of course, Battlespire, which we're going to be doing first thing first, because that's our first game. Then on Sunday, we'll be starting. So Sundays and Mondays are going to be Dark Sun. That will probably change because we just heard of some big schedule change issues for the future. So Fridays may not be Battlespire, but we'll see. And so we'll be doing Dark Sun, Shattered Lands. And then we're also doing, let's see, Ravenloft is on the list. Strahd's Possession, which is one that I've had owned that game for forever and never beaten, not even come close. And I was like, oh, that's a good one. Because I really want to get into kind of those first-person SSI RPGs, like Ravenloft and Mental Branzen and that sort of stuff, you know? And then also Sentient, which is a really trippy, open-world sci-fi adventure game where you're on a space station, and it's got a real time system. It's kind of like Majora's Mask in that regard, I guess. And you're trying to solve this mystery of this disease that's spread through the station. But it's also, the station is hurtling towards the sun and going to explode. And so you only have so much time to solve this riddle, solve these mysteries. And it's a really interesting game. It's for PlayStation and for DOS. And that was one that I couldn't get working on DOS for the longest time. And I really needed it because it has mouse support. And it's kind of essential. There's a lot of... It's a big, clunky UI, but it needs a mouse. But the only one that was pretty reliable was PlayStation, but I finally got it to work on DOS, which is great. Also on our list is War in Middle-Earth. One of my very first video computer games. I had it on the Apple IIgs at the time. This will be the DOS version, of course. And it is a real-time strategy RPG hybrid set in the Lord of the Rings universe, where you are going through the journey of the hobbits, but also you are controlling, you know, the armies of men and having to fight Sauron's armies and manipulating units. It's not a lot of resource management in general. It's more unit management. And so things are on a macro and a micro scale. So you're got big armies moving around, but you also have the individual characters, which you can split up or change any way you like, and you're trying to avoid the Nazgul and trying to recreate that whole the whole story of the Lord of the Rings, or kind of do your own thing. It's got Tom Bombadil in it, so it's an immediate success. Doesn't have them lazing around naked on a hill, which isn't a success, but it is what it is. Then we have some smaller games on the list too, some that can be easily beaten fairly quickly. We've got Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective Volume 1. That was a game I had on the Sega CD, and I loved it. It terrified me as a kid, but I loved it so much, and it's FMV. I needed to get some FMV in for DOS Ember, and I thought that was a good one, because I always wanted to just play those. So that's on the list. And then also we have Last Express. That's the Jordan Mechner adventure game. It's a murder mystery on a train, and with some time elements to it, apparently. That's been a bucket list one for me. I've never played it. I know very little about it, and it's been a lot of my friends' all-time favorites that they just love, and I have never had the opportunity to play it, and I was like, I need to, here's the opportunity. Those guys are going to be probably like Wednesday streams. They're pretty short comparatively, and we'll probably relegate them to those, where a bulk of our time is going to be on these bigger RPGs and that sort of stuff. We also got Kingdom and Kingdom 2 Shadowen. Those are what's the best way to was Dragon's Lair style game. And this was a huge one for me, because when I was a kid, for the longest time when I was in this arcade, I would remember this arcade cabinet that had like what I like attributed to be a full keyboard, and the buttons to it were like bubble, like how it kind of felt, had a kind of like a snap to it, like if you were playing like Trouble, the game Trouble, when you roll the dice, you have this little bubble in the center that you push down and it kind of pops the dice. That's kind of how I felt it as a kid, and I loved the feel of those keys. And like, just kid me, just remember that. And I remember just being like this full animated thing, and it was so complex and so wild, and I didn't remember the name for the longest time, and until like about a decade ago, and when I like was like, okay, I need to know what this game is, and I put it up to the internet and people found it, and I was like, oh. And I learned that like the arcade game ended on a cliffhanger, and there was a sequel on PC that was like the conclusion of that story. And I was like, oh, okay, well, then that's on the list now. I've got to play it. I got to know. I don't remember much of the game, but I just remember those keys and that feeling. Which, of course, is just, that's like pure ADHD right there. Like, if I didn't know, I was a sensory kid. Like, the feel of those keys is ingrained in my brain. And then also we've got Mega Race. Never played any of the Mega Race games, but of course, FMV. I've got Lance Boyle. Come on now. Come on now. Who would say no to that? And then we got a couple things. Like, I'm going to try, like, one day, like, not a full playthrough, obviously, but, like, Mario Teaches Typing. Like, I got to see what Mario Teaches Typing is like. I'm going to throw in some other Mario stuff if we have time. Some weird Mario edutainment. Mike says, lol, I just played Mega Race 1 and 2 very recently. I know you had said Mega Race 2 wasn't as good as the first one. I don't even know how they play. I don't even, like, I just know that there's FMV in it, and that it's very cheesy. Like, intentionally cheesy. And I'm and like, oh, sorry, Enforcer. You didn't get the job done. I know those things. How's it going, by the way, Mike? It's good to see you. So we're going to start off. So yeah, so we got Battlespire, Dark Sun, Shattered Lands. Those ones, like, I will for sure have beaten by December. And then we're going to try to get through more Middle-Earth, Ravenloft, Sentient, Last Express, Sherlock Holmes, Consulting Detective Volume 1, Kingdom 1 and 2, Mega Race. And we'll play around with Mario Teaches Typing. And maybe like the Mario, there's like a Mario game, like a parlor game Mario thing at some point. Excuse me. All right. Let's get into this though. Let's do some art. I'm going to shrink this down. And put this over here for reference. Oh, can I lock this? I probably can't. Oh, let me just shrink this then. There we go. All right. And then let's get you a little bigger so I can see better. There we go. All right. So we are going to attempt. Oh, Mike says, yeah, Mario's Game Galaxy. I played that in the 90s. Oh, baby. All right, so we're going to attempt to do this. So we got to change some colors here. Let's edit some colors. We got to get this color right there as close to it as we can, at least. That's going to be our background. Again, I am no artist. All right, let's get our background here. Paint everything that. Oh no, that's not right. A little more blue. There's a little better. And then we'll get some white going on here. We'll spray paint. That's our brush size. Make it big. All right. So, let's zoom out. Okay. All right. So we're going to do a little circle of this. I try and bring back Mickey's Space Adventure, the text with pictures adventure game with Mickey and some other got a possible death in that game. What? Dude, sign me up. There you go. Oh, got some Columns music going on right now. That's good stuff right there. This is already starting off wonderful, right? All right. Alright, so I guess we're going to have to try the letters first and foremost. We got to get... I'm not putting the Elder Scrolls Legend and all the little, like... I'm going to do Battlespire, though. I'm going to try. Oh my god. Hold on, zoom in for that. That's a zoom-in situation. Alright. God help me. Okay. Again, I am not an artist. I'm terrible at art. And we are doing this just for the laughs, because it's just very silly that we are making really bad box art. Okay. The music is making this very intense for me. So Mickey's Space Adventure being a text game with pictures, that's, dude, I have a love of that, like, that weird genre at the time of licensed text games with pictures. Like, I've talked to Mike about this a whole bunch. Like, I have a love for Perry Mason and the Mandarin Murder. I think that's what it was. It was a Perry Mason text with pictures. Serial. I don't do art, bogus. Proceeds to paint with the already hand of Picasso and the fantastical eye of Van Gogh. I have not streamed that one, Mike. That may be, if I get through all of these games, that might be one added to the list. We might just add that and play it. I played it as a kid, and I never got anywhere. I was terrified of one thing in particular. There was a outline of a body in it, and I didn't understand what that meant at the time. Because I was like 4. I didn't know what that meant. And I thought that was the body. That's how I assumed it. I assumed it as that was the body. And so I was terrified that that's what happens when you die. Was that you turned into an outline. Like a cartoon outline. It was really weird to me. And so I didn't understand or process that at all. Oh man. This is already going great. By the way, how's it going, Mascot? It's good to see you. But no, Perry Mason, so like, what I loved about it was really cool to have this simulation of like a courtroom scene. I didn't know who Perry Mason was as a kid. I didn't understand that stuff, but I was like, oh, we're investigating a murder. That's the first part, gathering the evidence, and then going to court, and then having to do like the court stuff. And I thought it was really funny as a kid, going into court, not knowing anything, and just typing objection over and over and over again, and they'd be like, on what grounds? And like, poop. And it'd be like, stop playing around. And kid me just thought that was the funniest thing in the world. And and later on, going into that, like looking back, going into it, and I was like, oh, that's Phoenix Wright. Like, this is just Phoenix Wright. And I was so like, oh, yeah, it was. Oh, this is a terrible tea. I'm gonna undo that one. That's a really bad tea. Not as still a bad tea, but better than what I had. I am so bad at this. But I gotta stream, yeah, Perry Mason at some point, because I really do need to like revisit it. And is it really like Phoenix Wright, or am I just imagining it with my fantasy world? It's unique tea, no mistakes, just happy little accents. Exactly. Exactly. Thank you. But no, as a kid, I played so many weird games that I shouldn't have played. Never in my life should I have played them. I don't know what my parents thought, because I came from literally like no money. We moved around a lot as a kid. Because my dad just job to job, and we were living in Sandusky, Ohio at the time. And I remember visiting my aunt in Rhode Island, and she had an Apple 2GS. She had, Task Times and Tone Town. And we saw that, my brothers and I saw that, and we were absolutely in love. And like, we want this so bad. And I remember my aunt being like, yeah, there's a lot of educational stuff on here. And with the way that the world is now, you know, the future's in computers. And I don't know how we got it. I don't know how we got an Apple 2GS. Like how we afforded it. But I remember the day we got it. Dude, Fried Rice, how's it going? I don't know how we got it, but it was the middle of the night. It was like 6 o'clock at night. So it was like super late in my kid's eyes, kid to me eyes. So it was the fall. So it was already kind of dark. The features can computers. How did we get out? How do we get out? I don't know. How do we get it out? Well, I mean, you're going to have to just try to gently stroke the computer. I'm ready to be uploaded. Just saying. Can we all just live in Tron world, please? Like, I would like to live in Tron world. So, it was the middle of the night. Not night, but for kid me, it was. I was like 4 years old at the time. And I remember going into the... This is a weird-ass S. Going into the store, and, like, my parents had already ordered it, and it's waiting for us. And the salesman showing my brothers how to do the stuff. And like me being like, oh, I need to learn too. I want to learn too. That's four. And my parents like, yeah. And even the salesman's like, absolutely. He was like so stoked. But I think he was more stoked because we bought all the fixins. So it was the monitor, the cooling deck, the two different floppy disk drive sizes, everything, you know, the mouse and all that stuff. And the dude was like super stoked because it was just a big sale. And so I learned how to do it then. And on the way home, it starts pouring rain. And I was legitimately, as a kid, like terrified. I was like, oh, I'm going to die. I had just that weird, like existential crisis. And I just remember getting home and we got that computer. It was amazing. He made a nice commission. Even the rye? Yes. And, but I don't know how we afford it. I think that my aunt bought it, because there was no way in hell. There was no way in hell. Like, at that time, we were living, before we had found a place to rent. Out there in Sandusky, we lived on a campsite. We lived in tents for like a month and a half. We were homeless. It was wild. And so I think she helped. She was rich. She was a rich aunt. she would always, like, that's how we got Coding in Quarantine. How's it going? Art. Badly drawn art, but art nonetheless. This is probably going to be the bulk of the box art is doing this lettering for Battlespire. But I think she paid for it, because there's no way we'd be able to buy that. But we had it, and I was never off that thing. I spent so much time on that computer. I remember it was where we lived, our house we had rented had two stories. And back before I was a factory, I was just a little operation at the time. I wasn't a factory. I was just a tiny little operation. So it was on the second floor. You go up the stairs, and literally, like, right there at the corner, right at the banister, at the end of the little railing, was our desk where we had it set up. And I would just spend all day on it. All day. There was a tutorial program on how to use, like, the mouse, like, teaching people what a mouse is and how it's supposed to be used, because it had a graphical user interface. It had an operating system, and it was Indiana Jones like character. Oh, this art is really janky. This is a bad art, but that's okay. Everything's bad in this world, and that's fine. I will never claim to be a good artist. But the thing is, we're going to do something with this art when it's all done. Don't worry. There's actually going to be a purpose for this art. And I can easily just grab this and shift it over so it's in the center. Like Pitfall or Bejeweled? So how it was... By the way, I blame you for getting me hooked on setting up EMUPR. Coding in Quarantine? Isn't it amazing? It's so much... To digress for a second while I'm doing my art here, I gotta keep drawing. One of my favorite things in the world is gaming inside of games. Why I love MMORPGs so much is because you game inside games, usually, right? There's little games you can play. Like in Ultima, you had chess and checkers that you could play, and I loved that stuff so much. And I love Shenmue. Shenmue is one of my all-time favorite game series. And why is that? Well, I mean, obviously, games inside of games. I feel that it's so immersive in my brain. The game is coming from the inside. So I feel that to be so immersive and just in drawing you into the world. Yeah, I know. Let me zoom out so I have a better view of this whole thing. Oh, shoot. That should be close enough. That's close enough. And it's so immersive, and I just feel sucked into that world. Mascot says, I remember a DOS game that was like Indiana Jones 3, collected gems and solved puzzles. Like, the arcade, Temple of Doom when I was a kid, I loved that so much. But, games inside games. I've been downloading old game ads and stuff so I can have an era-appropriate TV on the EMU. Yes! 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 Oh, baby. Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. That's the good stuff right there. It's so much fun to do that. EMUVR is so great. And you will expect to see maybe some of these box arts having an appearance in EMUVR. You may. I'm just saying. I'm gonna get some god rays in here. We need some god rays. Oh, jeez, that's too thick. Thin, please. Thin god rays, please. Oh, oops, undo. Need line. Here's our god rays. Look at this, dude. We've got a wonderful whatever it's called. Some thick god rays. Look at that. It's so beautiful. Anyways, back to the tutorial thing. So we had played, this tutorial was a Indiana Jones-like character. Hold on, I need to get some water. I'm going to be right back. I'll be right back, chat. I'll be right back. I need some water. My voice is all shot. I left it on the table and I had my breakfast. Alright.
Don't.
Bitch. So anyways, this tutorial. It was an Indiana Jones style character with a robot companion. And it was wild. It was so cool. And Kid Me loved it so much. So it had like little mini games where, oh, this Indiana Jones guy fell in a pit. And you have to crawl through this tunnel. Dwarf and Dad, how's it going? You have to crawl through this tunnel to get back up to the top side and reunite with your robot companion. And so you had to have the mouse over him and slowly move the mouse through the tunnel to get him up. And like, that's how you use the mouse, how to move it. And an obstacle would come and you have to click the button to remove the obstacle. Dude, DD, how are you today, my friend? We're one day away from DOS Ember, so we're getting ready for the big day. All right, so it's time to draw this person. Oh God, let's zoom in. I'm terrified about this, man. Okay. Here we go. Here we go. What you been up to, DD, by the way? What you been playing? No, tomorrow, Fried Rice. Tomorrow, Friday nights at 7 p.m. If you want to play, if anyone wants to play, let me know. We still got some spots open. We'll have a good time. The time is probably going to change because one of the big people, the organizer of DOS Ember, Artyom Havoc, is going to be joining us for the Battlespire playthrough on Friday, which is going to be so nice to have some new, fresh faces coming in and joining us. It's going to be a lot of fun as I struggle to talk. But 8-player multiplayer. Gather the stories of ancient times with trackball mouses. Oh, those were the days too. The beautiful mouse. I loved. Again, why the world didn't know that I had ADHD is beyond me, because I was obsessed with the feel of things. Like I said, I talked about Kingdom and the buttons. Another big one was the feel of that mouse ball, the texture of it. It was rubbery, but it was also kind of, it had traction to it. It wasn't smooth. I so love to play. Do I need to commit for the full line? And every day you play? So Fried Rice, we're doing it once a week. Just once a week. This Friday is going to be the start. We're going to be changing the days, I think, and try to get people organized for it. You don't have to, because it's drop-in. It's almost drop-in, drop-out. It's level-based. So you come in for a level, and it saves your progress, too. But you can come in at any level, you know, and join. So it'll be okay. But it is janky as all hell. Get ready. Okay, we got to make this pillar. All right, I'm terrified. Okay. Oh no, it kind of starts in the middle of the TTs. Okay. And it ends at the P. There we go. Yep, there we go. That's good enough. At the S. Yep, okay. End of the T. Okay. So I'm super stoked about it. I think it's going to be great. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. It's been a bucket list of mine because I owned it. Again, more tangents. I apologize. We're going to go all over the place. But I loved it because M Player. It's what introduced me to M Player. We got in Battlespire and we learned to have multiplayer. And my brothers were all like, yes, the multiplayer Daggerfall. I can't wait. We're going to play this. It's going to be awesome. And we downloaded M Player at the time. And it was, you know, that was like the only way to play it online. And guess what? Nobody. Oh, jeez. Undo that. No. Bad bogus. Oh my God. I'm hitting the wrong thing. Bogus? Focus, buddy. There we go. There's our fire. And nobody was playing it. We couldn't find a match at any point. No one played Battlespire. So we looked around at other games to play, and there was one game on there. It had just come out, and it was an MMORPG. It was Underlight. It was my very first MMO. It was the one that I played. I was obsessed with it. For better and for worse. That was a strange time in my life. Okay, oh boy. Okay. Get ready for this. We're drawing the person. Oh God. Gotta get that booty. There's my fem. Look at my feminine. Look at this feminine frame. It's so beautiful. All right. Anyways, Underlight was such a beautiful MMO that I had talked about a lot in my life. It's been a huge formative thing. But I should probably finish the body. Let's finish the body here. Hold on. Got the honkin' badonkadonk. Okay. What an amazing... Oh, that's so janky. Hold on. Let me make the head a little bigger. Got little buns. This is terrible. I love it. Wait, fill that in. Bill. Oh, jeez. Oh, I'm gonna have to paint that. I forgot I did the stupid... Oh, don't undo! Damn it. Game. I accidentally right-clicked. Right-clicking undoes what you're currently doing. Look at this head. It's so perfect. Look at that perfect head. It couldn't be better. All right. Again, I have no art talent. I want to stress this. Oh shoot, I gotta undo. I want to do the thinner. All right. So here we go. You ready? Arms, thin. Giant arms. Oh, that's magnificent. Oh, it's so magnificent. All right. No, that's not right. Oh my gosh. She doesn't. Oh, jeez, that's so long. What was I doing? Okay. I was just staring at the thing and not looking at the rest of my art. Ignatius was in deep pain when he drew this. No, not the box at the art. The one on the left. Oh my gosh, you have no idea. You have no idea right now the pain I am experiencing. So much bigger. Hold on, let me zoom out. She's so small. Oh my gosh. Hold on. Oh crap. Everything's so small. Can I select it enlarge? Shit. I was in zoomed in mode and I didn't think about it. Hold on. Let's undo everything I've done here. They're so tiny. I'm gonna have to do this over again, because they're supposed to be big. Select the area and resize it. No, because then it'll resize all. Oh, I guess I could. Can I select the area and resize? Let's do it. I can scale it, okay. I will, hold on. Wait one. That's better. We'll fix the paint. Let's see, let's fix the paint now. Perfect. Perfect. Ah, thank you, mascot. Okay, so let's make this thing. Because with paint, you don't have layers, right? You don't have the pleasure of being able, like, oh, this is on this layer. You have to take that in consideration when drawing this. This is so bad. I love it. I love it. I love it. Oh, is it bad? Okay. The air's looking perfect. Exactly. Okay. And then. Oh, that's beautiful. That's not even remotely right. No. Too small. There we go. Oh, it's so fantastic. This is pure art. This is pure art personified. It's so beautiful. All right, we got to make these wings. Let's fill this in as best we can. Oh jeez, undo. There's a line there somewhere. Zoom in. There's the hole. As you held aloft an enchanted switch banana, yes. Yes, how did you know? I just want this to be... Oh, shoot. It's not supposed to be black. Fuck. It's not supposed to be black. Hold on. It's supposed to be... Let's make it this kind of green. Oh, God. Fuck. Undo. Ew. We'll get it colored in fully. Here, let's get that all fully colored in. A little bigger. Kuno, how's it going, Kuno? Come to see my masterpiece and work, huh? This is truly a work of art. I love it so much. This is my baby. I wanted to keep the outline black, so let me get the black out and fix it. It looks so good. You have no idea. You've only just begun to see the true power of this artwork. Everyone's gotta have the black outline, because otherwise, how would you know what this is? It's mushed banana, of course. My poor hand is like a death grip right now on this mouse. Oh my god. See, that's what I'm talking about, the death grip. There you go. It looks so good. I'm so excited. It's fantastic. I just got some good Genesis music. I should have played, put some Battlespire soundtrack on. It's very foreboding. We're almost done with this piece. So brilliant. I'm a masterful artist here. Let's you back out. Do 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 do. Alright. So wings. Okay. Oh, I totally botched his wings already. Hold on. Let's try this again. So anyways, what I was saying before, at some point in time in this conversation, someone's talking about Indiana Jones games, talking about arcade life. I remember, so my early, I was a child of the arcades. So like, I grew up in the arcades. My parents would go to the mall. I don't know why they went to the mall. And I think my mom just liked the atmosphere of the mall. But she just dumped my brothers and I off at the arcade. And we were just let free. They gave them $5 each. I would not get any. I'd get to just watch. And if they wanted to give me some coins, they would. I'd usually get like 25 cents each. So I get 50 cents. Get to play like one game, two games. And the arcade games that stuck out to me the most, and probably because my brothers were so into like the movies and stuff like this at the time, but it was Indiana Jones, Temple of Doom. I remember that one a lot. And the big one for me that I spent a lot of time looking at was Return of the Jedi, because it had the cool controller in it, and I would just sit there and imagine playing it, you know, pretend to play, and kid me just loved it. It was a cool joystick. I have to remind myself not to pantomime right now. I'm drawing wings. Those aren't too bad. All right, now we gotta draw the, oh, what I should do probably first is fill in the color, which is this one a little darker. Biggest size? That's the biggest size. Oh, Jesus. Should we botch this then? crazy. Anyways, yeah, so like arcade stuff, my biggest memories for that stuff, I loved Return of the Jedi. I loved watching people play Dragon's Lair, and at the time that was really big. And I remember when fighting games became huge. Because again, I was a kid of the arcade. When we lived in Sandusky, we had Cedar Point, America's Roller Coast. And I was too young to ride roller coasters. So what did I do? I spent all my time in the arcade. It had a huge arcade, it was so cool. It had like Gauntlet, and like when X-Men came out, that was wild. It was a wild time. Because it had the big X-Men cabinet. I had never... Oh, shit. Why did I... I should have stopped, so I would have kept that. Because I accidentally right-clicked, because my poor hand. I remember X-Men Arcade, and I'd never seen the small cabinet. I didn't know there was a small cabinet. I always saw the widescreen one. Everywhere I went. So, like, I had, like, a bowling alley that had it. There was this Little Caesars used to have, like, a Chuck E. Cheese equivalent. Which I thought was the coolest place in the world when I was a kid. I remember when you come into the place, they celebrated a birthday. I don't know if it was mine or not. I don't think it was. It could have been mine, and I just didn't know. Because my birthdays as a kid, we didn't like have people over. Or didn't celebrate anything. Like, it wasn't a production. And going into the place, it was like in Lansing, Michigan. This would have been after we moved back from Sandusky. And I remember my parents are going in, and you're greeted with... But this would have been a Little Caesars version of it. This was by Little Caesars. This was Caesarland, is what it was called. And you're greeted with, as you come in the door, this little animatronic, or a little, like, coin-operated animatronic where you put in a coin and you push a button, and it was a crazy bread. There were little crazy breads on strings with faces, and they just start dancing around and laughing. And kid me, thought that was the funniest thing in the world. I loved it so much. My parents get really annoyed because I kept asking to go do it. Like, I want to see it. And they would just get really irritated with me. Mike says, I've been to that, but it was in a different city, and I only vaguely remember it all, and I loved it. And so the game that I, there at Caesarland, that I just wanted to play over and over again. Thank you, Sagra. Drawings look so good, isn't it? It's looking so good. Look at this. This is art. This is true art right here. True art in the making. How you doing, Sakura, by the way? I hope you're doing well, my friend. The game I wanted to play all the time there was Double Dragon. The original Double Dragon. I don't know why. I think maybe I know why. Because... Thank you, Fried Rice. Isn't it? It's exactly the same. It's like we're looking in a mirror right now. I've mimicked this perfectly. And it was Double Dragon. And probably the reason why I loved it so much or wanted to play it so much was because when I was a kid... No one, everyone, every person I knew who had a Nintendo wouldn't let me play it because I would break it. And I got so pissed off all the time as a kid because I used an Apple IIgs. So, like, I know how to use these things. I'm responsible. Do you know how to use an operating system on a computer? Like, do you know how to use a computer? And, like, so I was a kid, I had a chip on my shoulder about that. I was so pissed off about it. And so one of the things was I had a cousin who had an NES, and they never would let me play it, and they had Double Dragon on it. And I just wanted to play Double Dragon. That's what I wanted to play. And I never got to do it. And so when I got to the arcade, that was the one. That was the one for me. I'd play that and spend all my time playing it. Because I didn't get a chance to. And there was a movie theater that we had that had a Play Choice 10 or whatever it is. Staring at the sun, it's glorious. I know. Zerfall, I don't know. But they were all so insistent. I'm like, you cannot play this. Everyone else can. You know. And it was everywhere I went. And it hurt my heart. Because I remember, living in Sandusky, my oldest brother worked at a Chinese restaurant. And he made friends with the owner's kid there. And they had a sleepover, and we went to pick him up. They were playing California games on the NES. And they were doing the surfing game. And I was like, I want to play. And they're like, no, you'll break it. And I was... Like, I have a question. I've been told I'm really weird. How old is your, like, what is your first memory? To bring that up to all the people in chat, what is your first memory? Because for me, I'm like, two? 2 years old. That's my first memory. I remember the house I lived in. I remember all the details. I remember that I had Bugs Bunny sheets. Somewhere around two. People have driven over NESs. You won't break it. Exactly, Sakura. And for everyone else, they're like, I don't know, like 10? And I'm like, 10? You don't remember life before 10? Like, I don't know, 6 or 7? I don't know. It's like, you don't remember life in kindergarten? You don't remember first grade? And they're like, no. It's like, what has happened in your life that you don't remember those things? And I'm just like, here's all the stuff I remember, and I just go nuts. I go nuts over it. You start to say, like, hey, Bogus. What's your first memory? It's like, okay, let's talk about it. Like, I remember my first nightmare. And I say nightmare when I usually pronounce it. I definitely have memories as early as 3. Thank you, Mike. Thank you. I'm glad. I think it's us dorks. Like, us nerds. From what I've read, really emotional experiences are more likely to be recalled. Oh, yeah, tell me about it. A lot of negative ones, but I've been working very hard on trying to also include really positive ones with my negative ones. Really positive ones and my negative ones, yeah. Because I have had a lot of negative memories, too. I remember my 3rd birthday as well as a couple baby memories. Sarcastic friend, how's it going? Sucker says, 3 years or so, was an earthquake, and we hid in a closet, though it may be a false memory made through descriptions. So, I had this memory. This was terrifying. So, when I was a kid, we had a tornado in our town. This was in Stockbridge, Michigan. I would have been around 2 years old. And I remember us hiding in the basement. And one of the things I remember so distinctly is during that moment, in that fit of terror, I remember seeing this grisly old man face looking at us through the window of our basement. We had like a little window at the top. And I swore it happened and it was real. And my family's like, it wasn't. And I would see his face everywhere as a kid. And I thought I was going crazy. We moved to Sandusky, Ohio. And I saw him there. And I freaked out as a kid. And I was like, I have a ghost following me. Because my parents told me, oh, you must have a ghost following you. And I'm, 3 and 4 years old. And like, why would you tell your kid that? I'll do that. I got a hole here I gotta fill. And I remember like having a nightmare where I was going into our little office area in our home in Sandusky. And he was sitting in the chair, like looking at me. And I was so scared. And I was so happy that like when I moved, I remember like us leaving and like him waving goodbye, and I never saw him again. As a kid, I thought, because it was just my imagination, it was me being scared of being alone. It was attached to like moments of being incredibly anxious. And I was like, he's gone. Like, yes. The plot of The Sixth Sense. But it was because they, my parents and like my brothers and stuff, they played into it. And so they just fueled that fear in me as a kid. They were the worst. My brothers, they were the best and the worst. So, like, they always included me in things, and they always made sure to include me in things. So if they went out with, like, their friends, like, if their friends would come over, I would be included. And, because I didn't get in the way. I was never a kid that was, like, causing trouble or intentionally trying to cause trouble. And I wasn't always being, like, bothering my brothers. And there was a memory where we were in Sandusky, and my middle brother had a friend over, and we were, like, wandering the woods outside our house. We had this big field that led to the next house over, which was the people who rented the place out to us. And there was, like, a drainage ditch, a big one, you know, and all this stuff. And I remember on our way back, we had to jump over the drainage ditch, and I was scared. And, like, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. And they were encouraging me, and I jumped, and I went right in the middle, and it was filled with just mud. It was so gross. And I cried and cried and cried, and they got home, and my brother Ben was just like, you stay here outside, don't go in yet, all right? Don't go in. He goes in, talks to my mom, and I'm crying and bawling my eyes, like, I thought they were gonna kill me. I thought they were, I was dead. And my mom comes out, and it's like, let's get you washed up. And I was so confused, because I genuinely thought that she was gonna just scream and scream and scream at me. And I was like, my brother told her, like, hey, he's freaked out right now. Like, he's really feeling bad and thinks you're gonna kill him. It was great. Sorry, Zerfall says, I remember our first house, but specifically falling off the swing in our backyard, a trapdoor to the basement that I fell down, and my mom telling me I'd like apple pie, it tastes pretty much like applesauce. The texture haunted me for years. Oh man, Zerfall, I've been like the opposite with our kid. When we tore up the basement carpet, we found the old owner had crystals crammed in the corners. Of course, we put them back just in case. But years later, when my dad asked about what if there is a ghost in our house, I was like, oh, even if they are real, they can't get in here because of the crystals in our basement. That's fantastic. Sarcastic Green says, I'm a little stressed because of the end of semester stuff, but otherwise I'm fine. Oh, it's good. I'm glad it's okay. End of semester stuff's always stressful. So, like, what other memories do you guys have as kids? Were any of you arcade kids? I can't stress there. By the way, I think... Hold on. Let's fill in the Battle Spire with a little lighter color. Yeah, let's get this color in here. So it stands out a bit more. I think we're good on Battle Spire. When I talk about arcade memories, I remember the coin rats is what I called them as a kid. Not till much later, I occasionally got a quarter for the laundromat arcade machines. Oh man, they were huge for me. Cause you know me, like folks here know me. I'm a super impassioned person. So of course I remember everything. Cause to me, that was all life changing things. Everything was life changing. But I remember in the arcade, the coin rats were kids that were my age or a little younger. Whenever somebody put in a coin and it didn't register, and if you push the button to get the coin retrieval back, if you weren't quick enough, some little kid would come in, grab that coin and run. It was wild. It happened to me once, and I was like 5 at the time, and I didn't know what to do. The kid just grabbed it, looked at me, and ran. And I was like, oh my god. Miss Pac-Man. Oh, babe. Miss Pac-Man is the quintessential laundromat arcade game. All right, let's save it. All right, let me go. You guys have seen my private thing. So look. I actually don't know what this one is. All right, let's see. Box art. Bad Battle Spire. Genesis Temple says, hey, that doesn't look at all like the cover for Rings of Power. I know, right? How's it going, by the way, Genesis Temple? It's good to see you. Alright, we got one down. What's next? No, next is gonna be... This is blasphemous. How can I make art on a famous fantasy artist and do any justice to this? It's our fault since we almost never went to an arcade, but like every joint we went to had arcade machines, stores, pizza shops, bowling alleys. It's always amazing how much more advanced that they were on the home computer. It's user fault. When I was, again, like I, in the 80s, I had the Apple IIgs. That was far more advanced visually than a lot of the stuff we saw on DOS at the time. Go take her to the appointment, Kuno. Have a wonderful day. Thank you. Thank you for the good looks. There were some games that I saw in the arcade. Like, those were amazing. But then I was also like, I played Manhunter New York. That game, to me, looked leagues ahead of anything I'd ever seen, just visually. It was beautiful. I thought it was so cool. By the way, welcome, Genesis Devil. I do apologize. My voice is shot. And how are you, by the way? I hope you are doing well, my friend. We need a shout-out for the Genesis Temple. Stop, if you can do that, that'd be awesome. They are a wonderful, wonderful streamer and also game critic, games journalist with a massive, massive amount of talent. Start talking to them about the one, the only Rings of Power. Talk to them about it. Talk to them about Rings of Power on the Sega Genesis, not the show. Because legit, I'm so... I need to get some water. I'm gonna get some more water. I'm sick. I apologize. I'll be right back. Ask about Rings of Power. Just do the spiel. I'm kidding. Don't do the spiel. Do whatever you're comfortable with. But people ask him about Rings of Power. The guy who worked the morning shift had nicknames for all of us. Mine was Michelle. Mabel. For some reason. I think I didn't put much work into coming up with them. Just whatever our names reminded him of. Oh, I'm with you. Zerval, that's my life. Absolutely. Like, my daughter Rosalind. She's Rosie Bean. Princess Rosalind Bean III. Rosie K. Bozzy. And then my daughter Gwendolyn. She's Gwendolberry. Or Princess Gwendolberry III as well. And Winner Winner Chicken Dinner, because we call her Winnie, and Winifred, and just a bunch of silly names. Yeah, Winifred K. Winifred. We had a dog. His name is Forrest. That was his name. But we never called him Forrest. He was Fogey, Fogue, the Bogue, Bogey Buddha. That was his name. Well, he was Bogey Buddha. He got hit by a car. He lived. And afterwards, he was the most zen dog on the planet. He would smell all the flowers before he came back in. And he would sit and just watch, like, the sunset. Someday, I will do a 24-hour long play Twitch streaming of Rings of Power, and it'll be just two people. And then my life will be complete. I'll format my hard drive and never come back or something. I don't know. The thing is, Rings of Power is a Sega Genesis game. Y'all should play Rings of Power. You should. It's mandatory. It is a really fantastic computer RPG style game made by Naughty Dog. Open world. Nothing like it. Mascot said, we had a dog named Forrest, and if that dog was going somewhere, it was running. Oh, man. That is fantastic. Hold on. Doing good. That Battle Spire looking, I want to print it out and put it on my box. Genesis Temple, let me tell you something. Look, folks, here's the thing. Okay? I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to do a thing where, if you want, in January, every game we play is going to get, every game that we play, at least, spend more than like a stream playing. Usually one-off games aren't going to get box art. But, look, I'm a full-time stay-at-home dad. I don't, and it's by choice, but also by necessity now in our life, because of lots of life events. And I don't have a job, right? I do this for fun. I love this stuff. One of games should get a box art created with a 2-minute timer. There you go, Mike. Yes. There you go, Mike. There you go. There you go. That 2-minute timer. And so I'm going to offer these things up, whether in, for folks to have as like a pay what you want. I was thinking of like starting a $1 Patreon. We pay a dollar, like pay what you want for a Patreon. And essentially what you get, Mike, here's the thing. It would be monthly. And what you get is every end of every stream, starting in December, and the Patreon would be in January, you get all of the box art for that month. Because this is in the resolution of what the box art would be in, by the way. All of the box art for it, and a little PDF, a fancy PDF, not just like, you know, words on white, of haikus of all the stuff we played that month. So we'll be doing a haiku at the end of every stream that we do. So that's a lot, considering that I stream like 4 to 5 days a week. And you get that in a PDF. Sorry. As well as like a newsletter and like, you know, hey, I put up a blog post on, you know, some forgotten games, that sort of stuff. All right. So I got to draw this. You know what I should do? I need to draw the SSI first. We got to do the SSI logo. That's such an iconic logo in my head. All right. Let's try to draw this logo. I should use the line tool. Right about center. So, if people are interested, do they have a multi one? A multi point? There we go. Because I need extra income in my life, but also like I don't want to be that person who's like, oh, you know, I deserve it, or I'm, you know, I'm talented enough or worthy of it. I'm not like that at all in my life. But I definitely want to, if I was going to do something, I'd want to provide you something. And I thought that that would be fun to do. I don't know if anybody wants to be interested in that, but I came for the bogus. I stay for the meat. And it's, again, it would be a pay what you want. So it's like a dollar, you know? Like, I wouldn't dare assume that people should pay me more. I don't want to do that nonsense. I'm not that person. Shoot. Can I undo that? I can't undo that. Fuck. We're going to be a little crooked then, I guess. Solid idea, though. Would also be nice if you want to take requests, maybe. Like, love the vibe of the stream, by the way. Never been able to catch one because of time zones. Happy to find somebody. Yeah, so we are normally going to... I want to do a Thursday day stream all the time. Because I have a bunch of folks that I know that are in, like, the UK and in Europe. And I want to still, like, talk to them. And I'd love to be able to be in their time zone. And so I was like, oh, well, I can do a day stream then. And that'd be great. And... So I was very stoked about, like, Thursdays have been like the day for me, but so many things started just happening in my life, like, that I couldn't do Thursdays. Kids got sick all through the month of like October, the entire month. And then me getting sick now, but I'm trying my best. Let's see. Oh shoot. I totally botched that, didn't I? It's fine. This is why I shouldn't have done... Oh, God. I've really botched this. Fuck. Yeah. Oh, God, no! Oh, shit. You know what? We're hand-drawing it. We're doing it live. We want bad. We can't be. Cholex Z. No. It'll buff out in post. No. We're hand-drawing it. We want bad. We want bad MS Paint art. We're getting bad MS Paint art. That's what we're getting. You want bad MS Paint art, you're getting it. You're getting it, dagnabbit. Just don't right click. Stupid hand. Okay. And then I will draw, I will do the line tool for the bottom portion. Okay. But yeah, so like I feel bad, like there's always that self-confidence issue of me being like, I shouldn't ask people like, hey, do you want to pay money to me for this stuff? Because I don't see myself as that person. Like, I hate the word of like content creator and that sort of stuff. Like, I despise that label. It's not a label that I particularly enjoy or appreciate, because it's not content. I enjoy doing this stuff. I love talking games. I love just enthusing about it and giving people that opportunity to enthuse about stuff, because it's so cool. But I'm also like, we have to pay our bills. This is so bad. Oh, I love it. I love it. It's so bad. All right, now let's try. That's an arrow, I promise. I should probably zoom in. Why am I so zoomed out right now? Zoom in, bogus. Make it at least look like an arrow. The love of God. So I feel bad. And I don't want to make people feel uncomfortable, but like, this stuff will be available for that. You can have all this stuff. Alright, let's make the eye so that I can at least have a figure out like the how this S is gonna look. A little square. I love the SSI logo. This was, as a kid, I got very very familiar with the SSI logo. As I grew with my when we actually got a PC. Like an IBM PC. And because my mom was always a bargain bin person, she would always just shop for deals. And one of them was like the Forgotten Realms collection, I think. I still have the discs somewhere. They're here somewhere. And it's gonna be a really long S. Little longer. And that was when I was introduced to this game. And like Menzel Baranzin and Strahd's Possession and Strahd's Curse of Strahd or whatever it was. And I loved them. So like the Al-Kadim was one. As a kid, I would play anything I could get my hands on. Because again, I love video games so much. This is turning out fantastic. Oh shoot, that's supposed to go all the way to the... Hold on. That's supposed to go all the way out to the eye. Oh my gosh, okay. Oh baby. Hold on. Beautiful art. And so I would like start at the beginning of Menzel Barranzen a bunch and beginning of Curse of Strahd. Never, by the way, I will also add, never getting far in those games ever. And so, but Dark Sun was one that I just freaking loved so much. It was so good, and kid me, just thought the world of it. I was entranced with its world building, and I was just enraptured by, this is so botched, but that's okay. Enraptured by its world and its characters, and I loved Dungeons and Dragons, although again, my brothers never let me play. Because it would be just too complicated for me, because they didn't understand it much either. And I just always wanted to play, because they played GURPS and AD&D 2nd Edition, and I just wanted to be like them. They made games for me all the time when I was a kid. And that was part of like my love for games in general, is that it was always an indelible mark on what we did as a family. I learned Andy first when I was 8. Maybe it was first edition too. I don't know if it was second or not. When did first edition come out? Let me see. Or second edition, I guess. Second edition. Let me see. When did that get published? Oh, yeah, it would have been second edition, I think, at the time, yeah. It was the 89. But yeah, and they had just always like said, I was just, you're too young. You wouldn't understand that sort of stuff. And I was like, I get it. But I love games. And so like I remember they made this game. They used Ultimate Muscle Figures. This is one of my original ones when I had them as a kid. Ultimate Muscle Figures. And used Skip-Bo cards. And what they did was they made kind of like an RPG map of sorts. And I. Oh, jeez, I'm new. Come on now. Come on now. There it is, the SSI logo. It looks perfect. It looks perfect. Look at this. Perfect. That's exactly what it looks like. But they would make this game with those characters, and like it was like if you ever played Hand of Fate, a video game, it was that. It was that. But it had a kind of a war mechanic. It was really cool. And I loved it as a kid. It was my favorite thing. And they made that for me. Like they designed it and would put me on little adventures. How the fuck am I gonna draw this guy? Okay. In MS Paint. This is gonna be the hardest challenge of my life. Good morning, Artyom. Oh man, you came at a great time. I'm going to have to recreate this masterpiece of artwork somehow using MS Paint. How are you doing, Artyom? Thank you for the shout out, Sakura. By the way, Artyom, playing some Quake 2 last night. That was a trip. I loved it so much. Make sure he's still a beefcake. I'm gonna try to make him a beefcake. As you can tell, my voice is still shot. I'm still recovering, but I had some tea, taking lots of medicine, having drinking lots of water. Tomorrow morning, I'm just gonna bathe my throat in salt water. And look at the iconic SSI logo. How it's so perfect. It's 1-to-1. It's 1-to-1. Honestly, I think I may have been commissioned to draw this. I think that's what happened. All right, so we're gonna draw this gentleman. I'm going to first. Cause the, oh boy, we're so screwed. I'm so screwed at this one. I don't. Oh, I'm terrified. Let me zoom in a little bit more. Come here, big boy. Okay. Oh boy. All right. It's like you painted the logo with the blood of your enemies. Indeed. Yes. All right. So, cause the problem is we don't have layers, so we have to be very mindful of this. All right, so yeah, Dark Sun's at the top. You gotta remember the Dark Sun logo's at the very top, so we can't make him too big. So I'm gonna put his legs like right about here. Right? Yeah. Okay, we're starting the legs. Oh, I'm in red. Shit. Okay. Right about here. Okay. Here we go. Okay. And his leg is down here. Let's get some calf here. He's got so much muscle. He's such a beefcake. Such a beefcake. Look at all these muscles. Look at these muscles. I should probably use some skin tones here. You would think that one would probably want to use some skin tones for this definitions. So muscly. Look at him. He's so such a beefcake. Okay. Just wrong, like one of your French girls. Exactly. There we go. But sorry, Artium Havoc, you should follow him. Fantastic guy. Wonderful streamer. Going to be joining us on Battlespire tomorrow, and we're going to figure out a date, I promise. They are the organizer of DOS Ember. And a truly phenomenal person. They sell shirts. The DOS Ember shirt, on sale now. Go to DOS Ember, look at the merch section. It's worth it. I need to put my links up and get it as a quick thing. Look at this bad boy. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. All the names of the people participating who signed up by the deadline. There's 120 current participants, I believe. 120. And wild. Wild stuff. I'm so stoked. I couldn't be more happy for DOS Ember. Sakura keyed me in on this, and I wanted nothing more than to participate. That's the truth. That doesn't look right. That's not right. Go down here. 125, 126 now. Wow, nice. That's fantastic, dude. I couldn't be happier. And so the part of the money goes towards one, helping RTM continue to organize this and do this and pay for like the shirts and stuff. But another big portion of it is going towards members of the community, people who are in need, people who have a project they want to get started that they don't have the money to buy the equipment for. People who are just in need of paying the bills and surviving, or somebody who has something broke down and they need it replaced. It's to help the people in the retro computing like community. And that's really noble, because a lot of times it's like, oh, big charity stuff, and you don't know where that money goes in the end. It's in the ether. And while it's a good cause, but also like, it's nice to know that like it's going to somebody in the community that we are getting to know and we get to see, right? And like, that's huge. Genesis Devil says, I'm unearthing more, some obscure DOS. I saw the list. I'm so happy you're doing some Italian and Spanish stuff. That makes me so happy. All the money would go into the community somehow. I'm only taking $10 to pay for the year. Oh, the website. Oh, there you go. Sorry, thank you for the clarification. Who, by the way, did the art for the t-shirt? I'm curious. Who did that art? That was really good. Okay. Don't worry. That's not going to be all his leg. I promise you. There's going to be... Fractal Fun in my... Oh, dude. He knocked it out of the park. It's so good. That's fantastic. Okay. I'm drawing his little loincloth here. Because again, I don't know how this is going to work. I want to be exact, you know. And then of course I got to like deal with his eventual... Oh, he's so skinny comparatively. We're going to see how this goes. We're winging it. It's fine. It's MS Paint art. It's not meant to look beautiful. Okay? It's not. We're doing our best here. Muscle goes to the SSI logo. I saw Red Guard was $2.99. Oh, yeah, the sale ended yesterday, Monday. It's still not a lot. Always a good time. How's it going with Starbucks Rain, by the way? But you need to check out RTM because one of the big things that I love about RTM stream, the biggest, is he does LAN streams where they're playing games. LAN. And you don't see that very often. You really don't. Okay. And I love that. Because I'm a person who is very much... one's coming up mid-month. Nice. Yeah, he had said that. Yes, I was super stoked. That's kind of why we also have to kind of reschedule what day we're going to do Battlespire for. I'm doing great. So, I mean, I'm sick, Starfox Rain, but I'm doing all right. Overall, I'm okay. In the grand scheme of things, I'm not doing too bad. Oh, this is a perfect recreation. Look at this guy. This is ending up being better than I could ever possibly imagine. So stupid. Okay. Now we get into the torso section. Torsos terrify me. Especially considering I have no artistic talent. And I don't know how to draw people. I don't know how to draw in general. I'm just winging it right now. And this is the most daunting one for me. Oh, no. There's one more that's more daunting. There's one more that's more daunting than this. Oh, baby. There's one that's so daunting to me. I'm so scared. I'm so scared to do. And that's War for Middle Earth. Oh, God. On the muscles. He's holding a whip. Promise he has five fingers. Oh yeah, look at this tiny wrist. Oh, look at this tiny arm. That's such a tiny arm. Hold on. Oh, now it's big, big arm. Look at this, oh, it's so big. Look at the muscles. He's so muscly. This is some Trogdor level shit right here. Oh, baby. All right, let's just make a little design here for the muscles here. Let's get some muscles going here. Look how muscly he is. The most muscly man in the world. Look at the veins. Sakura heard me on Tuesday. I couldn't talk. The truth is I couldn't talk. It was impossible. Albeit is this box art is simple. Imagine Star Fox Adventures or Phantasy Star Online. Oh God. Yeah, no, we're not. No, terrifying. Okay, I'm drawing his little head thing. Face that's in this thing. He's got a little skull face. He's smiling. Let's see. Okay. And then I gotta draw this little thing. So this is all gonna also be in the virtual bedroom. Outside of Battlespire, which we can't play in the virtual bedroom. Every other DOS game that's gonna be in the virtual bedroom. if I can get it to work, is going to be on there. And in there as art. This is one of my all-time favorite games, Star Fox Brain. One of my all-time favorite games. Love it. It's so good. Okay, let's draw this guy's other arm here. How muscly he is. He's so muscly. I didn't add... Hold on, I gotta add some muscle to this leg. Because it can't just be a single thing. It's one of my all-time favorite games. I only beat it probably about 20 years ago for the first time. I really was like, I'm beating this game. I have to. And, let me get the guy's straps going here. So he's got a pauldron on his other shoulder. Comes up here. It's a bat, too. Oh my god. Why is he so detailed? Why are you so detailed, man? I like the Battlespire art. That was easy. Comparatively. Figuratively, because I can't draw with shit anyways. Do-do-do-do. Do 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 do. No worries, enjoy the shower. Why are you so detailed back when, in my opinion, box art was better? Yeah. I struggle with this. I struggle with this idea of drawing. Alright, so his arm, here we go. It's muscle. Another pauldron thing, a little arm thing. Oh, make a bulge. Okay. And he's got these riveted plates. And this kind of goes into the arm. Classic like Mega Man. Oh, baby. What classics indeed. I want... Because I made that museum, right? Of the Hall of Butts. We need a museum of bad box art. Like, we really need it. Okay, and then here's his hand. Knuckles. Thumb. He's gripping the thing, guys. Mega Man. Look at this. One arm is clearly larger than the other. Shush. It's okay. This is bad box art here. This is not meant to be good box art. If it was good box art, we wouldn't be doing this. Alright, let's see. He's so detailed. Okay. Strap. Here. Strap. One arm's usually longer than the other. Yes. Yes. Usually. Yes. Absolutely. Uh-huh. I'd like to be the contrarian. Phalanx actually is a perfect box art. Memorable, unique, and even vaguely related to the game. You know what? Also, you don't see a lot of, like, pictures of real people. You don't see that in a lot of box arts. Like, real photographs of real people. So, like, that is also incredibly striking in that regard. All right, we're gonna do this thing that I am also dreading. Let's make the head, everybody. He's got his little ear. Got his little weird ear. I love this. Yeah, that's a really broad jaw there. Me. Thank you. Okay. Gotta capture that square jaw there. I got a little better. Got a little better on that square jaw there. A little bit. Zoom in. All right. The eyes are the gateway to the soul. So I'm gonna do this. Oh, this is so bad. I love it. All right. Nose. Grimace. The sneer. It's perfect. It's perfect. I couldn't draw this better myself. Okay, let's get his straps in here. Shoot. Okay. Oh, look at this. It's so beautiful. I gotta draw his... This hand is so great. I love it so much. There. I added some things there. Added some lines. That fixed it, right? Oh, I gotta draw this too. He's got an arm thingy here. Let's see. Perfect. It's perfect. Shush. All right, let's draw his Gachakta. Look at that chiseled face of a Greek god. Gaze upon his masculine features. Looks like muscles to me. Looks fine to me. Yeah, it's perfect, right? It's perfect. This is exactly. Spot on rendition. Bow before Grok, the destroyer of worlds. Let's do some coloring so that I can at least get some distinction between what I am going to be drawing next. Because I don't know. Troy says, what are we doing here? Do you know how early it is, Troy? This is good morning. This is your morning coffee. Wake up time, baby. Let's go. I need a dark brown. Make it dark. Darker. Bigger. Okay, let's fill this in. Hopefully there's definitely holes. Hold on, there's holes. We're fucked if there's holes. We're fucked if there's holes. And there are so many holes. I tried my best to avoid the holes. So many goddamn holes. What is wrong with me? There we go. How's it going, Troy, by the way? No coffee for me, thanks, but happy to watch some art. Yeah, some brilliant art. This is the best art you're ever gonna see in your life. Shit, there's a hole somewhere. There it is. I see you, hole. Shit, more holes. Here it is. Hole. A bunch of them, actually. Jeez. Grok the meat of the world. Doing okay over here. Just sat down for work, but now I'm watching the creation of beautiful art instead. This is life. You're living the life right now. You're living the dream. Apologize for being a little under the weather. My voice is shot, but that's life. Alright, let's see. Armbands, yes. You can see the ripple of the muscles underneath. Not really, I'm getting to get rid of those muscles. We've already done one today so far. We did Battlespire. We got Battlespire all done, which was a good time. Alright, let's see. This one here's got to get filled in. Yeah, shout out to Troy. Art, damn, masterpiece. Now he's still a renaissance before our weeping eyes. Troy's fantastic, by the way, and you should also give Troy a follow. Really great person. They were just recently played. I loved this. He was playing an FMV shooting gallery game that came out recently for the Switch. And I guess PC as well, I think. It was great. Zombies. It was so good. I was cackling. I loved it so much. Alright, so you're gonna be that. You're gonna be this red too. So are you. Oh, jeez. No, undo. There's the hole. Get this red and make it a lot lighter. A little more brown, I guess. Oh, shit. Until the last bullet. Such a weird, terrible, fantastic game. Praise, how's it going, dude? It is bad, dude. Praise, do not compliment this art. Do not compliment this art. What is wrong with you? Do not compliment this art. How's it going, Praise? Good to see you. Shout out to Praise the Sun, by the way. Fantastic streamer as well. Good guy. Great. Wonderful, wonderful human being. A player of the Street Fighters. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Just, come on. Come on now. Oh, God. Zoom in more. Can we please? Okay. Fine. You want to play like that? That's fine. We can play like that. Let's just fill it in. One pixel at a time. Perfect. Okay. So, I'm going to take that red. A little outline here. What have you been up to, Praise? What have you been playing? Anything good lately? Yeah, that's gonna mess up. Do that. There you go. Yeah, I hope you've been playing some good stuff. Fuck. Alright, let's fix this. Can't have any open spaces. Love of God. No open spaces. Okay. Now. We go. fill in this one. And then black. Perfect. And then fill in black here on the inside of the eyes. Bam. We fix this one little pixel. There. It's like I'm looking at a true work of art here. It's perfect. This is amazing. This is the Mona Lisa compared to what I could do in MS Paint. I'm just fucking around. That's what I'm doing. I'm just fucking around. Let's get him his muscles. Let's get him his yeah, he needs his torso, baby. Let's get those pecs defined. Man, it's so shaky and inaccurate trying to do stuff. Well, I'm just doing it with the mouse too, so it's extra. It's extra. Extra janky. Which is why I love it. I do it in Mario Paint. Oh, yeah, baby. Let's do it. All right, let's give him his color, and then I gotta draw his chakta, or whatever this thing is called. All right, let's get a new color here. Light, almost yellowish. Need a little more yellow. He is almost yellow. There it is. There it is. Oh god, the holes. I'm dreading the moment when we get holes. Please, no holes. Surprisingly few. Oh, there's a hole. Surprisingly few holes, except for there. I think I know where it is too. Let's get the other stuff filled in. That's supposed to be white. Let's look for this hole. All right. Zoom in. Oops. We do. What have you been playing, Praise? What have you been playing recently? Anything good? Don't mind me. I'm still a little under the weather too. So like, I'm a little sick. Don't mind me. There's the hole. There's that bastard hole. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, we got holes galore. This one's such a difficult thing to do. All right. Got him. Let's get his eyes in a little bit more. Dude, this pupils. Let's get the sneer. Shit, not black. What am I doing? White. White. Oh, fuck. Come on, paint. There we go. Oh, damn you. A grimace. So great. It's such a great grimace. Alright. I gotta draw this thing now. I'm terrified to draw this thing. Off stream, working on Mesmer's MS Paint Master at work. I know, right? Off stream, working on my Witcher 3 Platinum. On stream, working through The Walking Dead Telltale. Oh, yeah, how is Telltale going? Probably one more stream until I beat it. And also working through Spider-Man 2.
Ooh.
How was Spider-Man 2? Tell me all about it. Because I won't be able to get to it because I don't have a PlayStation 5. But I would love to know how it's working out for you. Okay. This good song. I like the song. Okay, that's awesome. Combat's pretty cumbersome, but the narrative's fantastic. Spider-Man 2 just checks all the boxes for a new cinematic story game. Simply wonderful so far. That's so great to hear. I am kind of, just personally, this doesn't mean anything. I'm kind of tired of the Venom, like, story arc. Like that, the Black Suit Spider-Man, like, that thing. Just not doing it for me anymore. Which is fine. And I don't blame people for enjoying it. You know? Okay, let's try to make sense of this madness. Because I didn't do this first, and I should have. Because I'm deciding to now do it with this stuff already drawn. Wonderful perspective here. You can tell I'm like trying my hardest not to make this worse. There's a hole. Sorry, Venom story is slightly different in this one. Oh, still it's great. Been around for so long, we knew it was coming. How they introduced it is a fresh take, honestly, but I get you. Also biased, Venom's one of my... I don't blame you. Venom is such a cool villain. I'm not bashing Venom. I just feel like, I don't know. I don't know what it is. Like, I guess because growing up in the 16-bit generation and stuff like this, Venom was everywhere. And, like, all the time. Venom was... You couldn't escape Venom. And so, like, we always just heard Venom, 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 Venom. Oh, jeez, undo. Hole somewhere. Where's the hole? Let's zoom in. And so, yeah, so, like, you couldn't avoid it. And that was the kind of the thing, was that, like, I'm already kind of just, like, I know the story. And I watch the cartoons, like, I've seen the cartoons. It's like, I know all that stuff. But you need it still. You do. You do need it still. For those folks in the back who don't have that opportunity to know it, you know? Oh, shit. Undo. Undo our lines here. This is a tricky one, man. This is so tricky, this whole thing. So we need some little silvery. Little silvery. Here we go. Perfect. Thank you. And then let's add a couple lines here. Just to make this be a little bit more... A little more something. There you go. Oh my gosh. I think I'm done with the man. Am I done with the man? I might be done. Oh, I gotta give him some earrings. He needs earrings. What's wrong with me? I need his earrings. I should also probably add a couple more things here. He's angry. Now, Miles Games, man. Oof. Yeah, it's so good. That's what I like this take. It doesn't involve Flash or Eddie. It's a new take, but again, I'm early on, so I haven't actually met Venom yet. Okay. Yeah, I can't tell what you think. I can't either. I can't either. It's really... Now I gotta make the Dark Sun name. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I don't view. Okay, so I gotta make the logo here. The sun, and Jesus, took a long time. This is a lot longer than I thought. So we'll probably do this one, and then maybe one more, which will probably be like Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, because that's the next one I have to do. Like, that's gonna be this next week. Okay, so let's make this logo. Oh, I gotta make black line first, please. Thank you. Like my black outlines. It's so good. I'm so like, this is fantastic. This is the best. Okay. Let's go about the, yeah, I'm sensing a The Hills Have Eyes vibe in this much superior pain version. Oh yeah. Definitely the genetic gene pool has diminished dramatically in this version. For sure, without question. This is what I'm like now focused. The Adderall is kicked in. My poor brain is now like, yep, let's go. Let's go. All right. Yes, having a great time. I'm love it, man. I love this so much. Okay. So let's get our, let's start writing and then we'll put the background around it. So let's get Dark Sun in there. I can always move it if I need to. Because I always make my letters too small. Way too small, as you can see. Those that can't teach. Yes. Those that can't teach, teach gym. I should have been an art teacher. Absolutely. I should have. Look at me. Look, listen, kids. If you want to be an artist, here's the rule of thumb. This is a rule of thumb that I legitimately adhere to. I think this is actually really... Oh, jeez, that's going to be so bad. No, we need this to be out more. There's a rule of thumb that I remember I had heard. It's just like, just don't fucking care. Just do. If you want to create something, just create it. It doesn't matter if it's good. It doesn't. The act of creation in and of itself. Oh my god, that's so bad. the act of creation in and of itself warrants its existence and for you to make it. If you want to make it, just make it. And look, I'm living proof. Look at this bullshit. Look at this bullshit I'm making right now. Just, if you want to create, create. And I hate when folks, that's why AI art isn't art. It lacks spirit and creativity. All it is taking information and then trying to rearrange that information into something. There is only do or do not. There is no try. Exactly. Just do it. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if it's good. It doesn't, like, good by the eyes of other people. You made it. And that's awesome. I'm of the firm belief that, like, you should just make what you want and be creative. It's just part of that human, the raw human thing that is our need to create, our need to connect, an expression, right? It's just an essential part of it. And it's useful. Useful, sure. You're talking about AR? Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, like, it lacks. AI art just lacks the spirit. Because there are things that people do in their art that comes from no data point. It comes from nothing. Just sort of thought that, like, I wanted to do this. This is, you know, I had this idea to put, you know, sunglasses on the dog. And, like, if you were to say, like, draw me a picture of a dog, a cool dog, AR, it's not going to put sunglasses on it. But you got to tell somebody else. They're going to be like, fucking sunglasses, baby. And then you're like, fuck yeah, sunglasses, let's go. And you're like, that is so cool. Put sunglasses on a dog. I hate when people, like, look at something and go, oh, that's cringe. Oh, that's, you know, whatever. Comes from lived experiences, not data. Exactly, Mascot. But Mascot, isn't lived experiences just data? It's not. There's an interpretation to that data. It's an interpretation of the data. So, like, no, not the same. Oh, this end is so janky. Oh, that end is so janky. No, where are we doing that end? Pikachu face. But, like, I love that, like, my stuff like this, I'm just fucking around. I'm not, you know, I think it's just fun. Because I wanted to, one, I love doing bad MS, like, paint art, because I think it's funny. And I just enjoy it. There's my end. It's shitty, but that's okay. But two, I very much love just, I want to attach something to what I'm doing. What I mean by that is that, like, when I did haikus, it attached a memory to what I was playing. I stopped doing them just because there was some it made it hard to handle while playing the game, and I had to redo how we were gonna do haikus. I finally figured it out, which is why they're coming back. But, like, they attached a memory to these things. I had a better understanding, like, memory of, like, what I played that year. And I lost it, you know? Like, because I didn't have that, it was gone. And we're just gonna go one tone. I love haikus, too. Haikus are coming back, baby. I know you're not, it's not really this, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Kind of more fire red, or like a flame, but... Alright, let's get our grays in here. Because, yeah, memory's important. So, like, this was another part of me going, I want to remember doing this. I want to remember this. I want to remember this game. I want to remember making this and like sharing this with you guys and just having fun with it. You know, it's something that I want to have still in my brain. And if I don't do it, I'm gonna forget about the game. I'm gonna forget about the stream. There it is. Hold on, I didn't get it right. No, I didn't get that right. That's not right. Zoom in. Oh, not out. In. There. And then I need that darker color again. Boom. Oh. Not that one. Sorry, a lighter. There it is. Oh, hold on, we're not done yet. We gotta add the background. I actually noticed now for the first time ever the world below Dark Sun. Yes, right? Oh, the... Yes. So let's draw the sand dunes real quick. Just gotta have some sand dunes. And then we'll be done with Dark Sun. Gotta remember to, not leave any holes. Is. Alright, now let's get... Oh, there's definitely going to be a hole here somewhere. There is right here. Alright, let's get our sky in, which is really light. Let's see how this looks. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work. And then... Then we gotta get our mountains, which are a little bit darker, so let's edit that color. Just a little bit. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Oh, shit. Cool. Yes! Oh, dude, this is for you, Praise. Get some Street Fighter music going on in here. I love it. And then a little bit darker, even more. No, yeah, a little bit darker, even more. Just a little bit. There it is. There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the second box art for DOS Ember completed. Dark Sun. Missing the arm. Oh, right here. No, this is supposed to be white. There's these white bands right here. You can see right here. That's the white band. Sorry. Yeah, I picked up on that for some reason. Oh, look how beautiful that is. It's a masterpiece. An absolute masterpiece. Spikes. Thank you, Sakura. Spikes. There you go. Spikes. Right, let's save it. Bad Dark Sun. I'm gonna grab some water real quick. I'm gonna grab a refill because my voice is shot. And we'll start on the next one, which is gonna be, I believe, we're gonna do a smaller one, which is gonna be Sherlock Holmes. Look at this bad boy. Look at him. The PC Sherlock Holmes box art. Get ready.
I'll be right back. Stay there. Don't move anywhere. I'm gonna be right back.
We got a lot of work to do, man. We got box art to make. 10 out of 10 would play. And just again, these are being done in the resolution of the actual box art for it. Sherlock Holmes is going to be a little bit different, but we'll make it work. We'll make it work. I can resize it and change it later. All right, so I've saved this, right? It is saved. It is, in fact, saved. Holy crap. Oh, shit. I made it. Oh, not. Oh no. I didn't finish. There's one thing. There's one thing. An important thing. Holy crap. I can't believe I didn't do this. Fuck. We gotta change it. We're not done. The sun. You need the sun. Holy crap, you need the sun. Oh, I need that to be black. I'm sorry. Not done yet. I gotta have the sun. Fuck. Can't believe I didn't do the sun. That's essential. You need the fucking sun. How can it be dark sun without the sun? The shitty sun, but that's fine. And then it goes. Okay. Hold on. We need our line tool. One more thing. This is so important. I can't believe I forgot this. How does one call themselves an artist if they forget the sun? Let's see it further out. 1 second. Okay. Gotta fill this in. I'm so sorry. Here comes the sun. Da 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 da. Here comes the sun. It's alright. Little darling. Because when you make the sun. Hold on. I need to zoom out now. Zoom out. Okay. This color. Let's make this a little darker. Wow, shit. Got a hole. Where's the hole? Zoom in. There's the hole. You son of a bitch. There's a hole here, too. Almost done. Sorry, everybody. I couldn't forget the sun. I saw that. I was like, oh, shit. We need the sun. How does one live without the sun? All right. And then we fill this in with black. Oh, shit. We got a hole. Fuck. Got a hole. All right. Let's see. Where's the hole? Oh, there's the hole. Bam. There it is. Now we did it. Dark sun, dark hole sun, black hole sun, baby. How can you forget the sun? You can't forget the sun. There's the sun. Now we can save it. Saved. Good. New. All right, now we're doing Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Volume 1. Okay. I am not going to even attempt. No Shattered Lands text. No. We're just doing Dark Sun. Just Dark Sun. There it is. It's perfect. All right. How am I going to do this? Drawing Sherlock Holmes is going to be a pain in the ass. Okay. So. I'm trying to think about how I'm going to solve this. Okay. So let's see. It's so ornate. It's so ornate. Oh my god. This one even. It's like a tangled web. Hold on. Hold on. Are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? Get ready for the awesome, my awesome art of Sherlock Holmes, the writing of Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective. Ready? Block art. This is just what we gotta do. It's just how we do now. This is our life. Because I'm not even gonna attempt to do this writing. That's insane. It's insane. I can't draw that. I can't even, like, fake draw that. Can't fake draw Sherlock Holmes. That's so insane. Like, oh. I mean, that's what I'm dreading with, look at this. War in Middle Earth. Like, I can do this. Right? But look at the detail on this armor and stuff. Like, how the fuck am I gonna do that? I don't know. I'm so screwed. That's okay, though. It's okay. It's fine. Sherlock Holmes. Because that's the right consulting detective. Ugh. I might write that in, literally in the text, with the text thingy. Because I think that'd be funny. This is ridiculous. This is so stupid. Let's see, Sherlock Holmes. My headphones, hold on one second, my headphones went out. So I'm just making sure there's no ads that run on the music that's playing in the background. So yeah, like, we were talking earlier just about, like, arcade experiences and, like, just our earliest memories. Does anyone have any early childhood memories who have come in for the first time, have not heard us rant and rave about these things? Because, like, I can sit there and talk forever about my memories as a kid. And, like, just, I went to a place that was called, I went to a kindergarten, it was called, from a place called Furry School. It wasn't furry, it was Fury. But I thought it was furry, and I thought it was just very funny. My parents got me into kindergarten early. I was four at the time. It was wild. And I did not stay in that kindergarten. It was so stressful as a little kid, being 4 years old and having to, like, go to school and be there really early and also be a kid with, like, undiagnosed ADHD. I panicked. It was weird, but I remember going there in Ohio when I lived in Sandusky, and it was such a crazy time. I was just thinking back at it, like, They had nap time still, like, and I was a kid who was just like, I don't take naps. And the teacher would be so pissed off because that was her time to smoke. She'd have the window open and just smoke. And she's like, but you have to be asleep. Kids have to be asleep. It was so wild, like, that idea, like, the teacher needs a moment to smoke. And that was the thing that, like, we talked about, like, a lot, like, one of the biggest things that I think that kids will never know. They'll never know that, like, everywhere you went, you couldn't escape it. Everywhere was just heavy with smoke. It was everywhere. Every restaurant you went to, arcade, the mall, the doctor's office, people were smoking everywhere. It was wild. And, like, not a lot of people recognize that at all. Let me change the size of this. You're gonna be really small. No. That's not right. No. You know what? We're not doing it. We're doing it the right way. We're doing it the old school way. Consulting detective. We can do this. Consulting. Oh, jeez. And I just remember as a kid, like, everywhere we went. Remember smoking sections? Like, that kept smoke away from the non-smoking. Yeah, right. McDonald's had, like, a smoking and non-smoking section, and they're just in the same room. Yeah, it was just, like, it was just, over here is where people smoke. Over here is where people don't smoke. Still smell like smoke. And I remember, like, the difference between my grandmother's house. Because all my uncles smoked, like, big time. And I remember when they stopped smoking in businesses and things, they didn't smoke in houses. They'd always just smoke outside. And I just remember the difference in the smell of my grandmother's house when it wasn't covered in smoke. It was wild. It was wild. But yeah, like, that change. I remember people fought so hard about it. Bowling alleys don't smell right anymore. Oh, Artyom! Oh, you gotta see it. We gotta see it. Oh, I'll show it to you. One second. Let me pull it up for you. There it is. There's Dark Sun in all of its beautiful glory. How fantastic is this? All people smoke inside their homes, so their homes don't smell like onions and liver. It's truly a work of art. Absolute masterpiece. The SSI logo. Oh, mwah. Dude, hit him up. How's it going? Welcome. A fine rendition, right? Oh, I have to say that I put that artist to shame. That stellar, iconic artist to shame. Show him the previous. Oh, yeah. That's not the first one. Here we also have Battlespire. Here's Battlespire. So good, right? Look at the god rays. Look at the god rays. They're so good. This is the best. Yeah, this is our Battlespire art. Truly phenomenal. I am an artist of epic proportions. Feed this ego. I actually have that Sherlock Holmes CD-ROM. Dude, nice. I got. So let's do story time more. More story time. I was introduced to Sherlock Holmes for the very first time when I was a kid. Michelangelo would be jealous. I had the second CD. It was Christmas. Rich Aunt once again. Coming back. I have to draw a realistic human being. Okay, let's start with the hair. Look at that, that's perfect. Right? This is perfect. She got us the Sega CD for Christmas. Oh, look at that beautiful hair. Oh yeah, that's spectacular. And we got to open one Christmas present early. The night before. And we knew, like, she always comes through with awesome Christmas gifts. When we got the Genesis, my brothers had pooled their money together and bought the Sega Genesis. She got us, like, 8 games. She got, like, Quackshot starring Donald Duck, Castle of Illusion starring Mickey Mouse, amongst other things. And, we were like, what is she gonna get us this time? And it was a Sega CD. And it came with a compilation of stuff. It came with, Soul Feast. The Genesis collection, which had Streets of Rage, Golden Axe, Columns, and Revenge of Shinobi, and Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective Volume 1. And I still have my copy of it too. Did she get you Pocahontas? I wish. But and so we got to play it for a little bit. And then my brothers and I stayed up until like 11 o'clock, which was late for us. We'd go to sleep at like 8. And we plopped this guy in. The very first case has a dude who's like, I'm gonna resurrect this monkey from the dead. And he does this little ritual. And it doesn't work, of course, because it's Sherlock Holmes, baby. And low-key best, really, I've never played Pocahontas on the Genesis. I gotta play it at some point. Shadowrun was a big one for me as a kid. I loved Shadowrun. Quackshot starring Donald Duck was really, really good. Anyways, so I remember that night dreaming as a kid, as one would do. Again, we're using a mouse for this, so this isn't easy to do. He's gonna look real janky, oh my god. Dreaming and reliving that scene from Sherlock Holmes, and it succeeding, and it was like a puppet dancing around, a puppet monkey dancing around, and I was so terrified that I couldn't see that game ever again for a long time. I was like, never gonna open it up, never gonna play it. So I just played Soul Feast a bunch, and I played a bunch of Streets of Rage. It's like the stunning Prince of Persia light with RPG elements and two characters to control. What? That sounds amazing, dude. Everyone always talks about Lion King and Aladdin. No one talks about Pocahontas. I didn't even know. That's wild. All right, let's get the rest of this guy's head in here. Okay. Look at my wonderful art. This is a perfect head. And so, yeah, only on the Sega, the other got ported, not this one. Oh, really? That's so interesting. I remember that it was during that time of Lion King and Aladdin and stuff like this. That was like the time, the only time that I remember, like, video game critics going, oh, the Sega Genesis is actually good. Oh, Jesus, I really like that noise. I'm gonna zoom in. But I remember, like, that was the time when they're like, oh, the Genesis is good. The Genesis is actually really cool. And as a kid, I was like, yes, the Genesis is cool. Thank you. Look at his little nose. It's so tiny. Mojito does not feel good. Why, Mojito? Why? This is art. Why are you afraid of art? What happened with art that you're uncomfortable right now? I hope you're feeling okay if it's really sick. Never played a Sega game until you convinced me to play through Shining Force. Dude, and how fucking awesome was Shining Force? How awesome was Shining Force? You think you have COVID? Oh no, Mojito. I hope you feel better, my friend. I thought I was making you sick with my artwork. But I hope you feel better. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear, dude. I thought I was making you sick with my art. Alright, let's see. What are we gonna do for this face? Okay. Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, dude. Butts. Serial Arcade, my friend. How are you? Shout out to Serial Arcade as well. Shout out to Praise the Sun. Why aren't you getting shout outs to everybody? Serial Arcade's a really great streamer as well. Plays a lot of retro stuff. Really great guy. And we'll be... sometime next year, I'm guessing, maybe next year or in 2 years, we'll be playing Wolverine on the NES, because I haven't forgotten our bet. Second channel so far. Okay, perfect. Yeah, how was EverQuest going? Or Champions of Norrath? Dude, you're playing Champions of Norrath? What? You're playing Champions of Norrath? I don't believe it. I shan't believe such things. That's amazing. Our bet's still going. Have you seen the Japanese man make beautiful art on Excel? I've not. Can you throw that in the Discord for me? I would love to see that. He's got these big lips. No, that's not right. Wow. That was not right. That's not right. Don't do that to our boy Sherlock. No, not right. Don't do that to our boy Sherlock. Don't you do it. Oh, it's a masterpiece. This is like looking into the eyes of an angel. North November. Oh my gosh, that's so awesome. That's so awesome, dude. I gotta get back into playing Champions of Norrath, because Lip and I and my good friend Nick were playing it. Oh yeah, this is a spitting image of the man. Okay, let's zoom back out a bit. Oh, look at that. Oh! It's like looking at... Oh my god. Oh. This is... Oh, baby. Fuck, that's just... Oh, that's so good. I'm just so gonna cry. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. I've never seen something look so beautiful in my life. Wow. Let's he's got his pipe, but I'll get to the pipe. Let's just get his frame going here. Let's get his neck. Shit. Oh my god. I'm gonna pee myself. That is so beautiful. I can't even with words right now. All right, now let's get his little coat. He's got his coat. And then, what's his arm? It's his arm, yes. Neoclassical impressionism? Absolutely. How did you know? All right, and so, let's just do it. There's his neck. Give the semblance of a neck. You know, you and I both know. That's not how this is gonna work. Wow, that's just, I can't wait for the pipe and everything. This is just, oh, this is so good. This is so good. I can't have made this better myself. This is art. We are now bearing witness to true art. I like the champions. I'll probably do Return to Arms sometime in New York. That's fantastic, dude. I really wanna get back to that. That was such a fun game. It's one I've always wanted to do too, co-op with folks. Alright, so here's his coat, okay. And then that goes down. He's got his little... Oh my god, that's not right. Let's not do that. Let's not do that to poor Sherlock. We've already put him through so much already. I'm sorry, Sherlock, old boy. I'm sorry to have done this to you. Okay. I am dying. Poor Sherlock. Holy crap. Okay. Let's get his arm in here. Here he is holding a pipe. This is my fingers. Get ready for the fingers, guys. Fingers are the window into the soul. You ready for this? Oh, this is... Oh, that's so great. So beautiful. He's holding a pipe. Artwork at its finest right now. Okay. He's holding a pipe. Look at that. Beautiful knuckles. That one's a remaster. Just not sure who has the license for Champions of Norrath. Daybreak has the EQIP, but not sure if that included the Champions games. Yeah, because Sony Online Entertainment made it though, right? Who developed it? Who developed it? Look at these hands. Big, strong hands. These hands are so strong. They couldn't save my friend. Oh yeah, this is art right here. Oh, this is when we start to breach. Snowblind developed it. Okay. Yeah, that's tough. Then who would who would have the rights? We're Snowblind right now. Are they still around? Should be closer to his face, but you know what? I don't care. All right, so let's get his outfit here. Da 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 da. 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 Da 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 da. We did get the fairly lazy remaster for Dark Alliance games, but there was no online play. However, since Champions has been built, has that built in by default, you'd think it'd be a no-brainer. I'd love them for to bring back that, to bring back the Hunter of the Reckoning games, even the Fallout ones, you know? Those weird Fallout ones. I'd be down for all of that. Like, sign me up. Alright, so now we've got the tie. So we got this down here. This is the best thing I've ever seen. This is what we call a masterpiece in design. So we got the tie here. And then man, we got so many holes we gotta fill up. But I grew up, like, so when I was a kid, I remember playing the Fallout games and Hunter the Reckoning with my friend Joe Fear. He was, I was just thinking about this the other day, too. I looked up my old podcasts I did as a youth. I would have been, like, 25 at the time or something like that. I did a podcast where I talked about, like, games and stuff. And it was terrible. Absolutely cringe-worthy to great effect. And I remember we did like about 12 episodes, something like that. Hunter, yes, Serial Arcade, yes, Hunter, yeah. Same style, you know, same kind of stuff. It was enjoyable. There's 200 games. I think they made 200 games. Let me give him his little white sleeve. There we go. Wow, this is shaping up. This is shaping up. Hold on. Look at how great this looks. This is fantastic. Perfect. Looking at last year's stream is like that for me. So I don't mind the stream stuff so much, but like, yeah, this would be over a decade from before. Because like I... Yeah, I mean, absolutely, it's still pretty cringeworthy in the end, but, like, I kind of embrace that stuff, but, and of course, this was, you know, I was, like, 25. Language was very different back then. I will say, language is very different back then. I do not entirely endorse all of the things I may have said. I wasn't like, a horrible human being, but definitely, like, there were some words in my regular lexicon that I would not use today. That's for sure. You know, they weren't like anything horrible, like anything like truly like, oh my God. But like, if you said it, somebody like, you shouldn't use that word. And it's like, oh, okay. Like, that's kind of where it was, more than anything. It's like, your brown eyes. It's so beautiful. And his black eyebrows. Let's give him his. Oh, how's this color? Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect for him. Absolutely. A little darker for the lips. Yes. Oh, look at this masterpiece. This is so beautiful. All right. And then he's got a... Oh, God. Fuck. Okay, hold on. I gotta make his... Hold on. What's the skin tone for this? That's this dropper. There. And then he's got his pipe.
He called for his pipe, and he called for his bowl, and he called for his fiddlers three.
Yeah, like it's a bit of a navy in the tie. Oh, damn it. Okay, where's the hole? Zoom in. Like 8-bit, yikes. Yeah. So I definitely want to one day. Oh, shoot. Wrong thing. Coloring the tie. There's the hole. Want to make a horrible incentive where we listen to my one episode of this podcast. Because there are still some things in it that are like legitimately, oh, that's it. Like, oh, what? Because I like the very first one, I talk about playing the Zork online game. It was an online browser game. Oh, come on. No, where's the other? Where's the hole? The Zork Online, oh, there it is. The Zork Online game, which is really interesting. Sherlock Holmes consulting director, you do you, hey, Aizen, come on now. If you can't draw as good as me here, oops. Look, Finn, I don't think you could talk the talk right now, unless you walk that walk. Getting old is not kind on the bones. I feel you, dude. It hits you in these waves, too. It's wild. I did not expect the waves to hit me like they do. There are waves where I get a certain age, and it's like, oh, God. So we gotta do something like this and make it darker. Because it's a more, yeah, for this. Pink. There we go. Detective. Yes. Consulting detective. Now it makes more sense. Oh, undo. Blink. Give me that brown. Okay. Sure. And then even lighter. So we take that and we're gonna go here. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Let's take this and make it lighter. There we go. Where's the hole? How are you doing, by the way? Listening to Bogus talk about old age while he sits there in his mid-20s and full head of hair. Yeah, right? Yeah. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Who wants to do that? Who wants to do that? Nobody. Nobody does. But let's look and close the hole. Zoom in. That should do it. Let's see. There we go. Perfect. Let's zoom out. There he is. Look at him. The pinnacle of just amazing, amazing attire. Okay, now we got to get his chair. Is the next thing we're building. Is his chair. Okay. Right here. Chairs should be easy, right? Chairs are easy. Let's do that. Okay. This was on Sega CD, but also on DOS. And this is the DOS box art. But as a kid, I played, in this podcast, I talked about playing this Zork online adventure game that was like a multiplayer game. It was a browser game. It was really interesting. And I dug it a bunch. And I did this podcast with Joe, and he and I were always kind of like the creative partners and stuff. But it was always such a difficult time because he was a really talented artist, but he never would finish his projects. And we'd made this podcast. He just kind of stopped. which kind of sucked. And then we also we did this webcomic, which I was insanely proud of. Like, it was so good. I wrote it, and he drew it. It was so good, and I was so proud of it, and he just stopped. Sounds familiar. I've been trying to finish more projects. Yeah, and I have forever, like, tried to... Oh, jeez, undo. Fill in my holes. To get, like, I can't get those comics that he made, that he drew. He deleted, like, all of them. And they're all gone. And it makes me really sad. Because, like, that was really something, like, genuinely something that I was proud of. We did that when I was in, like, my early 20s. And they were really cool. Let's see. Boink. And then, and that lighter yellow. There. Oh, no, not the same color. Let's do this. There we go. Oh, shoot. I forgot. Let's get that. Dropper. Thank you. Bam. Oh, shoot. I need to also drop this. I gotta get the behind the. All right. Let's see. Okay, so we got the chair now. Now we need the window and also the thing of ice. Okay, so let's get that. Okay. We've already succeeded. Like, this is already an art that is a success. In all sense of the imagination, this is already a success. But still, we must continue. That's a fine curse lush, isn't it? Oh my gosh, it's beauty. It's beauty incarnate. You can't make a better Sherlock Holmes than this. This is obviously one of the best. One of the best in the biz. Alright. And then we'll color that. It's a bit of a navy for this thingy. Navy. And then white for that. We're fine. How are you doing, by the way, curse lush? It's so good to see you. I'm gonna have to run, sir, but got a work meeting. I have to go for, like, oh, dude, Serial Arcade. Well, good luck, sir, and thank you so much for the resub, my friend. It's so good to see you. Enjoy the meeting, or try to at least, okay? Alright, so there's a big window behind him. It's enormous. I'm not making it that big. We're gonna cap the window to, like, right here. Almost done. This was a quicker one. I mean, obviously, I don't know why I put in a lot of work and detail into this guy. Let's see. Yep, there's a little crossbar behind him. Okay. So, we are going to fill this in with black behind him. Bam. Oh, shit. Undo. Fill the holes. There we go. And then a lighter gray crossbar behind it. Oh, just do holes. Bam. I think that's it. Oh, no, there's not. Oh, shit, there's not. What am I thinking? Whoops. It's not done. Hello. We have an important feature that we need to include. Shame on me. What is wrong with me? Still shaking, the morning cobwebs out of my head. I feel ya. Sherlock Holmes? I thought that was Fabio. I thought it was an Adonis. Honestly, I thought it was Adonis. Red. Get a white. Alright. So, volume. Oh god. Hi. And then a magnifying glass around it. I'm going to sneeze.
Perfect.
I think so. Excuse me. Oh. And there it is. Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective Volume 1. Bad Sherlock. Alright, let's see what else we can do. We gotta at least crank out one more. Let's do sentient. Look at this one. Look at him. How beautiful. Let's get Sherlock out of the way. Goodbye, Sherlock. Goodbye, Dark Sun. Sentient. Oh, look at this. Toasty. I saved you, right? Bad Sherlock's there. Bad Sherlock is there. Alright, saving just in case. New. Alright. So, first things first. I'm not going to do Den Aufbrücher in die Uwendlichkeit. No, we're not doing that. We're just doing this portion here with the sun. Let's get our sun going. Why not? It just rolls off the tongue. It does. All right. And let's get our... Let's get some... Oh, the holes we are going to create in all of this. Oh, the holes that we will create in all of this. All right, let's see. Yeah, we're gonna make a little bunch of little holes everywhere. This is awesome. I love this. So this game is one I've been so excited to play in forever. And I've never been able to get it working just right. So this is a crazy, most people don't know this, Psygnosis made this. It is a an open world adventure game, first person, on the PlayStation and DOS. And it is, you are a investigator or who's come to search about this disease that's broken out on the space station. The space station is also, I will add, hurtling towards the sun and the solar system that it's in. And it can't escape the gravitational pull of it, so it will burn up soon. But you can't get the people out because of this disease. And so, it's all done in a real, like, time system. So it's timed, it's a ticking clock. But everybody has a routine. And everybody goes through these motions, you know, it's kind of like Majora's Mask in that regard. There's like 20 different endings to this game. There's also like some cult that's going around. You're hallucinating too, to make matters worse. And it's such a wild game. And I had the demo for it way back in the day and I was so enchanted by it. But I couldn't get it working on modern PCs. And then, and you need a mouse. You need a mouse. It doesn't work for the PlayStation. It has a very convoluted, like, conversational system about tone, topic, subtopic, sub-subtopic, and, like, just huge lists of information. And it's like, you can't just do that. You need something else. All right, so let's build our spaceship. Oh, man. Okay. Let's do this. Okay. Not a good start. Not a good start. Boink. All right. And then
Look at this. This is a thing of beauty. It's got little antennas on the side. Don't forget those little antennas. They're important. Okay. But anyways, so I played this demo of it, and I was so enchanted by everything that it was just doing. It was such a rich and fascinating concept. And, yeah, I really wanted to play it for forever. It's so strange. It's such a strange game. And that's part of, like, why I am attracted to those things, because strange games, again, we talked about this so many times, you can be bad, but you're interesting. And this is one of those instances where I feel like the game isn't that great, but I am interested in it. And I want to see, like, where this will go for me, where this game will go, and where it's going to take me. All right, so. Okay, and then we got our next big one. Oh, it's too long. Too long! Okay. Now we got our big dish. Not a big dish, just a bigger dish. Look at this beautiful art. Oh, it's so majestic. All right. Space station is something else. I don't know if anyone ever played Sentient or ever heard of it. Because I don't know of anybody who's like, oh, Sentient, yeah, like that. Oh, yeah, I remember that game. I don't know of anybody who's like, oh, yeah, I remember Sentient. I don't know what it is with me, why I have to play these types of games. Because they're just so damn weird. I gotta be bigger than that. It's bigger than the last. Come on now. We've got a big bowl. Never played it, but to be fair, games in that era were a dime a dozen. It's true, Mascot. Oh, that's you're telling the truth. They were a dime a dozen. You're absolutely right. And that's part of why I also feel that, like, PC games do not get the love, I need to redo that one, they deserve. Because there's so many things that kind of fall through the cracks that are interesting, you know, but not necessarily great. But they do some really interesting ideas and try to tackle such interesting concepts. And this is one of those games that does that. It has such an interesting concept. Alright, and then we gotta make your. Okay. Now we gotta put little spiky spikes. Oh, it's too big. That spike is too big. That's not a fountain. And now let's see. Okay, so this part's gonna be kind of blazing red hot. let's get a red, make it more orange. Go. Kill that bad boy. Oh, holes. Oh, there's so many holes. So many holes. Let's fix those holes. Fill up my hole. And then this is gonna be real dark here along here, so this is gonna be black. And then this is the metallic gray. Ish. Take this color, lighten it up a little bit more. little more yellow. Put that here. I need another ring along this one. Enjoy. Hey, Praise, thanks for hanging out, man. Enjoy work. Hopefully it's a good day. Where is our... Oh, there's a hole. Is it the very apparent hole? What was I thinking? In here, too. There we go. That should do. Perfect. Shit. Holes. You dirty, dirty hole, you. And we'll get that same color here, put that on here. Microsoft, paint me like one of your French girls. Always a pleasure, Praise. Have a wonderful night. And folks, again, you should be following Praise. He's such a great guy. So worth it. So great. Let's zoom in. Zoom in. Zoom in. What time is it? Yeah. We'll probably end at 1. Oh, hold on. I gotta go blow my nose and get some more water. I'm gonna be right back. Whee! Enjoy the music. If there's any left. Is the music still going? My headphones have stopped working. Yeah, I'll be right back. Whee! I'm gonna mute this one because you don't want to hear me blow my nose. It's not a good sound. Hello. This is just the German box art, Mito. I have no idea. It was Psychnosis, so I don't know. I don't know where they are. I forget these things. I know not these ways. There we go. Let's start this back up again. All right, let's zoom out. Let's see. View, zoom, out.
All right, now let's get our Coriolis effect. We gotta get the little wispy woos. Wispy woos are the fun part. You have to do wispy woos. Okay, so like here, right? You're gonna go. This is the sorry. I'm making sound effects for this. This is so stupid. All right, let's see. Excuse me. All right, and then we need to get some more around the planet side of things. Do this, we'll go. I can't do this without making that sound. It's just inherent in me. Was the voice acting in the game also in German? No voice acting, all text. So it's all in text. Well, I guess there was English. There's cutscenes, and they were in English. And I remember. I'm so sorry. Psygnosis got bought up by Sony and it became its studio Liverpool, yeah. Okay. Alright, so let's color these guys in. Let's see. We want to do kind of a burnt sienna. it's a little darker. There you go. There's that. And then heating this up for yellow. Oh shit. Bam. 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 Not bam. Anti-bam. Stop with the bam. 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 No, not that kind of bam. Alright, so there's a hole here somewhere. Oh, I see. Okay. There we go. Let's make this a little more orange. There. No, it's the same color as the other one. No. Let's make that a little bit lighter. Maybe? A little more yellow. Bam, bam, bam. Nope. Not that kind of bam. Bam. And oh, I gotta fix this thing over here. That's what I gotta do. Let me fix you here. Let me fix you here. And then we get to do the fun part, which is drawing the face. Let's draw sentient first. I can feel the heat radiate out of that sun. It's like I'm really there, right? Right? Dude, I'm with you. I'm with you. All right, so let's write sentient. It's in, oh, okay. That kind of sucks. Okay, let's just do it in black. It's fine. Let's zoom out. Okay, starts at the very far left. Sentient. In my wonderful black letters. Wow. What was that? What was that? sentient.
We like fun. We like fun. We're having fun. Aren't we having fun? We're having fun, damn it.
There are also these letters are so supposed to be so far apart. Oh, let me move you. There. Antient.
So happy that I was able to get some FMV games for Dawsember. For those who don't know, tomorrow is the start of Dawsember. We'll be playing DOS games all month long. It's gonna be a real good time.
We're having a mandatory fun. I'm so excited. You know what I'm most excited for? I'm most excited for Easter. I'm ready for Easter. I was gonna do it in December for Christmas.
Until Stockware reminded me, or told me about Dawsember, and that I needed to sign up for this. I have a game that I promise you, there are no playthroughs online of. There are probably 3 videos of around a minute in length of this game. It's called Journey to Heaven. And it is about an astronaut going to,
I'm doing a T. I thought I was doing an I there for a second. I was panicking.
Going into space, and when he goes to the asteroid field, the asteroid belt, he gets into an accident, and he dies. He wakes up in heaven, or in reality, at the gates of heaven. And he's greeted by a very long-legged, big-breasted bimbo-looking lady. Like, that super tan body, blonde hair, you know, giant long legs, wearing very little clothes. And that's his grandmother. And she is there to guide him into bringing about the end of the world. And so he has to journey to heaven and, like, have the seraphim sound the trumpets. And it's a first-person adventure game, Myst style. She does a lot of prancing, I will add. A lot of prancing. Prancing on water. Prancing all over the place. I can't possibly tell you what in the hell is going on in the game. I have played just a tiny bit of it, and I can safely say it's insane. What are you doing, step-grandma? Not step-grandma, just grandma in this case. Just grandma in this case. Dude, Fernley Flynn coming in with a raid. Welcome, raiders. Sorry that I am my voice is very ill. Welcome, one and all. You guys are in for a treat. Let's do a little art show for all the raiders coming in. Simon, good morning. You're missing the fun, my friend. Shout out to Friendly Flynn. Wonderful streamer as well. We love our day streamers. Day streamers unite. We love the day stuff. Puzzle, how's it going? So look, we're doing Sentient in MS Paint. Look at how beautiful this is. This is really great. This is a fantastic entry. So I'm gonna show you guys what we've done so far. We won't be able to complete all of it, sadly. What were you playing today, by the way? Dawsember is coming up tomorrow. And we are playing all DOS games for the month of December. And so I have a list of games I want to play. So I made box art for all of those games. Recreating the box art of the original. Still working on Final Fantasy VII. Oh, don't feel bad. You're doing great. And this is what I've created. Oh, jeez. Hold on. Oh, spoilers. There's the first one. Battlespire. Elder Scrolls Adventure Battlespire. Elder Scrolls Legend Battlespire. Recreated the box art. Here's what it originally looks like. Hold on. Bam. There's the original. Look at this. It's like looking in the mirror, right? The next one we did was of Dark Sun Shattered Lands. Get ready. This is what we got going on right now. Look at this. Oh, look at this. It's like they're indistinguishable. They're indistinguishable, right? Obviously. You can't have seen it better. Well, look at this. This is, oh, baby. That's some pretty cool MS Paint skill, right? Oh, it's so fantastic. The next one we did. Hold on. I don't want to spoil anything because it's not in any order now. It kind of went out of order. Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Volume 1. Now, if you have any weak humors, any children around, please hide their eyes. What I present to you, the beast that is Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Volume 1. Oh my god, I love it so much. Oh, it's so hilarious. It is so bad, and I love it so much. They're the same picture. It is so good. Seven Cats of Forest. These are actually generally pretty impressive MS Paint work. Why, thank you, Seven Cats of Forest. Thank you, sir. Beauteous indeed, right? Truly, truly. And so we're working on Sentient right now. That's what we're working on at the moment. And we're almost done. We have a whole bunch more games to do. I've still got Kingdom Far Reaches and Kingdom 2 Shadowin, Last Express, Mega Race, Ravenloft, oh boy, and War in Middle Earth, which we'll have to do probably in the next day stream. I recognize Dark Sun, Battlespire, and Sherlock, but I don't know Sentient. Most people don't know Sentient, Simon. It is a first. It is not right. I'm under the weather. Sorry, everyone. I am sick. So Sentient is a first-person adventure game that is kind of Majora's Mask-ish. You have a time limit, a ticking clock. You are sent to a space station that has contracted a unknown virus, and it needs to be cured. There's a cult. They're hurtling towards the sun, and so you need to find a cure and to get everybody out safely. They all have, I know, Mihito, it's okay. You didn't get me sick, Mihito. We shouldn't have kissed, though. We shouldn't have. But it was worth it. And so, you were sent in there to save them before they crash into the sun. And everybody has a schedule, and you have this big, intense conversational system where you have moods, you have topics and subtopics, and moods can also... moods are environmental, so like if you walk around being angry, people will respond to you as such, and they have their own little things, and there's a billion different endings. There's like 20 different endings, a whole bunch of different things that you can do, and it's a bunch of different like side stories and things that'll all kind of help you understand this, and you're meant to play this kind of over and over again so that you can learn and build your routine to figure out like what's the most efficient way to do this, because you have that ticking clock. And it's also on PlayStation 1 as well, Simon, to make it even more ambitious. Is Fallout a DOS game? Yes. Fallout is a DOS game. Yes. Fallout 2? Maybe not. Well, Fallout 1 is, I think. Need to put a little guy on the tip of the station going, I'm king of the world! And so yeah, it's a really ambitious game, and it is very, and it's first person, and it's 3D. And it is something. It is something to behold. That is for sure. I never beat it. I played the demo. And you need a mouse. And I was like, I can't play this on the PlayStation. And it was really hard for me to get it working. And I only finally now just was able to get it to work, which is wild. Yeah, Fallout 1 is the only DOS one. I'll be lurking pretty hard, but I absolutely love this. No race 7 Castle Forest. By all means, lurk away. Thank you so much for coming in. And thank you, everyone, for coming in with a raid, and thank you for raiding me. Like, that, it's very kind of you. So I really do appreciate that. It's always nice to have folks come in and keep you company. We're talking about, like, memories, because I was waxing poetic about, like, my childhood. Yeah, I lived in, Sandusky, Ohio when I was a kid, as well as here in Michigan. I'm a native-born Michigan kid, but this end is so janky. Let's fix this end. Let's try this again. And yeah, just waxing poetic about like raising in arcades and having the Apple IIgs and all that good stuff. It's good to stop by. My stomach. Yeah, no, eat food. Go eat. Take care of yourself. It's good to have you. Thank you so much for the raid. And you, yeah, go eat. Raid and run, I get it. I get it. Don't you worry. No need to apologize. Feed me.
Ugh.
All right, so yellow for sentient. Let's get this. Let's get this in. Let's make sure there's no holes. Oh, there's a hole there for sure. Ah, God, holes. Let's zoom in. Fix this. And then let's see. Oh, there's the hole. Check the E. I's okay, T's okay, N's okay. I think everything else is good. Let's see. Let's give it a shot. There we go. You really match the two different teals well in the battle spot cover art, right, Simon? Go to quarantine. Yes, hello. Oh, welcome, Raiders. Holy crap, I didn't even recognize that. Sorry. Welcome, Raiders, indeed. Folks, Coding in Quarantine, a wonderful, wonderful streamer. Ran into Coding to Quarantine through my time in Mastodon. Really great guy. Playing Chrono Trigger. I voted on that poll. I voted Chrono Trigger. Just so you know, I voted on that poll. That was my vote. Welcome, everybody. Really awesome person. You should definitely give them a follow. They're really cool. How was Chrono Trigger treating you tonight? I hope it was doing well. We're doing bad MS Paint right now, box arts. This is our life. This is the life we've chosen. And this is the life we have to live now. I've got to make this face. Playing in AMUVR, yes. Did you put any posters up yet? Have you put up any custom posters? I gotta know. If you put up any custom posters, I'd love to know. All right, let's get this guy's head. All right, let's zoom out. And by bad, he means breathtaking. Because you were in here earlier. Do you guys want to see him? Let's see. I'll show you my art, okay? Here we go. This is the first one, Battlespire, right? It's based off the artwork of Battlespire. Here, look at this. Look at that. Look how fantastic that is. Half the custom poster. Yes, half the custom poster slots. You might be seeing some future custom posters right here. Great cover. Yeah. Oh, iconic. And then we got Dark Sun Shattered Lands. You're like, bogus. How could you even attempt to parallel this great work of art? Easy. Easy. Like that. Look at that. Oh. Look at this. So good. Thank you for the GG's puzzle. Yes. It looks pretty scorching. Yeah. Oh, baby. It's super good. This is like the best work I've ever done. Then we have... Oh, no, not that one. Hold on. Then we have Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective Volume 1. Now avert your gaze, those of ill humors. Where I show you the beast. There it is. I love it so much. It is so bad, but so good. Oh. It is the pinnacle. The pinnacle of art right here. I've definitely played the Sherlock Holmes game. It's so good. I love it. And now we are in the midst between sentient. We just gotta draw the face. Oh, there's another face there. I didn't even see that lady's face. Oh shit, we got two faces. I didn't even notice her face. How did I not notice that face? Okay, let's try the face. Big face. Great about doing this guy's face is the fact that it goes into the sun. He's covered up by the psychosis owl and text. I can wing it. I can make it happen. Got big honking sunglasses. This makes it easier. My really great ear. That's a great ear. It's one of the best ears I've ever done. All right, so let's go big. Oh. That's way too big. Oh, do that.
too big. We're doing this with a mouse as well, which adds the insult to the injury, which I love. I love a good challenge. And then another eye piece. Let's see. All right, let's get his nose. Let's see what we can do. Okay, fingers crossed. Let's see. We can do this. He's got little things. He's a little full brow. Sure. So you can see if it's an eye. That's perfect. It's beauty. It's beauty incarnate. All right, and then we're gonna get his nose. My nose. Stop this. Cease this. Cease this nose, man. There we go. Nose. 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 No, look at that beautiful, look at that schnoz. Just, it's just perfect schnoz. All right, let's fill in his nose. Because I'm an artist, I'm great at this. I'm great at art. All right, and then let's see. Okay, so green for the glasses, right? Let's make it darker. It's a darker green. Get an eye color there, but it looks like this, but a little lighter. So we're just gonna make this a little lighter. Oh shit, holes! Got holes! There's the hole. There. Bam. Perfect. It's perfect. Let's get his lips. Gonna make the lips now. Look at this little pretty boy. We got his lips. Let's see. Look at him, he's so pretty and majestic. Alright, and just a little. Let's get him, he's tan. He's tan. So let's get this. Make it a little deeper. There we go. Got some holes to fill. You can see him. Few holes. Let's see if that worked. Ah, shit. Nope. More holes. Where are you, holes? It's at the top here, but I don't know. Let's see. There it is. And then let's get the black outline here. We're gonna fix this hole. There. Now his kind of a, it's a little reddy. Reddy, a little lighter. Let's see. That's right. Yeah. That's perfect. I gotta add some. He's got a little bit of stubble. He's got a bit of stubble. Let's give him some stubble. Look at this. This is beautiful. Look at that stubble. That's immaculate. All right, now we got to draw her face. Got to draw her face, and then we got to call it a day. All right, her face. I mean, let's start here. Let's see. Right? Draw the eyes, the gateway into the soul. That's not right at all. Let's see, hold on. Perfect, oh, that's perfect. Look how close they are to the edge of her head. It's obviously the right thing right there. It's perfect. It's looking identical. They look identical. It's like I'm looking in a mirror. All right, let's see. It's hard to do with that sentient. I have to make things up. No, this is a botch. Abort, abort. Okay. Hold on. Get the lips first. This is perfect. This is better. Oh, so good. Eyebrows. She needs eyebrows. She's got eyebrows. He does not. Kuno, welcome back. Art is looking great. Kuno, we've made so much art. Oh my gosh, so much art. What ones did you see? I don't even remember when you left, Kuno. Forgive me. This is the last one for the day. I hope the appointment went well. You just saw the battle spot. Oh, you're in for a treat, Kuno, my friend. Let me just get this lady finished up here. Yes, hole. Okay, let's get this lady drunk. She has kind of hazel eyes, it looks like. Hazel eyes to me. Oh, shit. Holes. Yeah. Okay. Alright, let's make her skin tone. She's got a lighter skin tone. Bam. Totally need one for Apocalypse from PS1. Oh yeah! Tell me about it. All the art. Let's do it all. Oh, hold on. I got a hole here I gotta fix. Excuse me. Slowly dying. No, wait, please. Let's get her some lips. Yeah, red. Red lips. Red lips. Bam. Can't really see her hair. Alright. Oh, I forgot the skin tone here. Boink. There. Alright, now we gotta make it kind of a... It's kind of a black-blue, so it's a little... It's not quite black.
Okay. And then we're going to add a little bit of white. Like just the cosmos. The cosmos. Stars. You need stars, right? Everybody needs stars. Your little stars. I think that's good, sentient. Yeah. Oh, that's amazing. Couldn't have done it better myself. Look at this. Oh, you have. Excellent, Kuno. What are you going to play? What are you going to play for December? Save as. Oh, shit. Whoa. Hello. Back. Bad sentient. Bam. Holy smokes. So let me show you. Let me show you my creations. All right. Let's start with, of course, we had Battlespire. Let's review these once more. So we have Battlespire. Of course, based on this wonderful artwork. So great. Can you not? There you go. All right. Bam. Perfect. Then we're like, hey, Dark Sun. Here you go, Kuno. This is for you, my friend. Are you ready? Dark Sun. Bam. Look at this. Look at this masterwork of art. How I match those tones on that bat chest piece. Oh. So good. Look at that. Dark Sun. Fantastic. Fantastic work. The SSI logo? Come on now. How could you go wrong? Then. That's not the right one. Hold on. Then. Here's my best work. Best work is Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Volume 1. Prepare yourself, Kuno. Prepare yourself. No, that's sentient. There it is. Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Volume 1. How could you argue that? Look at that. Look at just how fantastic that is. I wasn't even going to try to do the font for that. That was like, it's so dumb. It's so dumb. It looks, he's so janky and I love it. So janky and I love it. And then we have, back one, sentient, which we have here. And there's the two. And that's it. I am my own best work. I think so. I think this is, yeah, I love this. I'm proud of this. Thank you, Bajito. I'm proud of my artwork. It's adding a level of memory. I'll never forget these terrible artworks. Thank you, Mojito. You're far too kind, my friend. You are too. You are deserving of all the happiness and love in this world. Absolutely, without question. All right. So with that in mind, we need to go find someone to raid. Let's see who's on. Let me turn that off. You don't need to do either of them. I will be back tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Battlespire co-op. At least 4 people right now. If anyone wants to join, let me know. Thank you. Thank you all for the raids. Thank you all for coming in. Thank you, my good friend Serial Arcade, for the resub. Everyone is far too kind. Thank you for coming with me on this journey of bad art. It's so good. December participants, all the people going. All right. Let's go see who's on. Audio Eric, hello. Audio, did you see the art? Look at the art. Hold on. Audio Eric's here. Hold on. We gotta tell him. Dark Sun. There's all my list of my games. Don't mind them. Boom. Look at this art. Look at Battlespire. Beautiful, right? You saw all the art? Okay. I didn't know. You've been lurking. I didn't know if you how long you've been lurking. All right. Who's on? Not a lot of people I know. Not a lot of folks. I don't do the day streams very often. Let's go say hi to Captain E-Rock, because he's playing Ark Survival of All Ascended. Ark Survival Ascended. And another Michigander. Let's go say hi to him. We love our day streams. Thank you. Thank you, Audio Eric. I'm glad you enjoyed. Thank you all for talking with me. We'll probably do this again next week, Thursday, too. To wrap up all the other ones. Maybe. See how I'm doing. So I'll be back tomorrow at 7 p.m. Enjoy, guys. Let's go raid Captain E-Rock. Captain Erob. Oh, one word, please. One word. Bogus, you got this. I can do this. I can spell. I promise. Have a wonderful day, have a wonderful day, everybody. And as always, to humor. Take care. Bye.
Fa, 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 fa. You say I'm just a punk and useless junk. I'll say I can hang on just a little bit more. I still can walk, I just can't run.